8 points in the ECAC, and Sloot in a tie for seventh place with 6 points. Sloot with a 2-2-2 record overall in conference play. And Clarkson really doing some good things after not many people thought they would come out with much of a season. But Sloot really, on the other hand, coming out pretty strong as well, playing two different styles of games.
Certainly these teams have different styles. We've seen Clarkson, while they have those bigger defense, they like to play a little quick transition game, try to get up the ice quick, but they do like to rely a lot on their defense to hit you down low. They like to use some of those bigger bodies that Will Frederick, Matt Zarbo, some of those guys have down low to cycle that puck and work it around. And really contrastingly, we've seen St. Lawrence, they really have one fantastic line up front with Greg Carey and his brother Matt really out there controlling the pace of play. They like to get up and down the ice really fast, get shots on net, be in transition, use their speed, their skill, the great shots they have to get up the ice and push the tempo. And that's what we're going to look for St. Lawrence to do here tonight, especially with that dynamic brother combination.
Of course, St. Lawrence coming into tonight, leading the nation in goals scored, not necessarily goals per game, but 61 total goals scored by this Saints offense. Very potent up front, of course, led by the nation's leading scorer. Greg Carey leads the nation in assists and points per game. So Greg Carey, really a potent force. His brother Matt coming in, taking the place of Kyle Flanagan, that Canton local who graduated last year, wearing the same number. So we'll see Matt Carey out there with his brother Greg on that top line for the Saints. And Matt Carey putting together one heck of a year in his freshman campaign as well. But the big story coming in, the St. Lawrence defense, a little bit young, lost some key players on the back end. George Hughes, one of them. His brother Gunner, though, still on the team playing up front. Young team, though, back on the back end for St. Lawrence. And really, with St. Lawrence liking to play that run-and-gun style, some of the freshmen getting caught up in the offense. They've been beat on plays, and that may play well to Clarkson's advantage. Clarkson kind of a team that likes to stay home on defense, really play well in their own zone, and then counterattack and kind of shove it right back up your throat, give you a little dose of your own medicine. So Clarkson, we'll see if they can take advantage of that young D-core of the Saints.
Well, we know they have a young D-core, but they're led by their senior goaltender, Matt Weninger, having a bit of a down season, up in the 3-6 in the goals against, but he's definitely a very good player, is the senior goaltender, plays well for this St. Lawrence team every time Clarkson comes, tries to take on the Saints. They're going to lean on him a lot, especially with those young D and the fact that they like to jump up. You're going to see all those St. Lawrence players up on the rush. So if Clarkson's going to win this game, you know they're going to have to transition out, try to get their speed, get it up to Al McPherson and Ben Sexton, let those guys get in with speed and try to put some pressure on the Saints and Matt Weninger.
But if you look at who's going to change the game for these two teams, look at Greg Carey for sure. We mentioned him before, 1.89 goals, or excuse me, points per game average, leading the nation with 29 points. And then, of course, if you look on the other end of the ice for Clarkson, some tend to fly under the radar. One of those guys who's done so, except for last Sunday in that exhibition game, he had 4 points, 2 goals, and 2 assists. Look at Jeff Dinalo, not the biggest guy on the ice, but certainly one of the more tenacious guys for the Golden Knights, not afraid to throw his weight around down low, and he can be mean down in the corner.
Jeff Dinalo has really stepped up his game in a big way for this Golden Knights squad. We've seen him score some critical goals, had a goal in the game of last year against St. Lawrence in Placid that ended up being the game winner. He's been very good for the Knights team. He likes to pester the opposing squad, not just with his scoring, but we know he's a smaller guy, but he's not afraid to get the body, take it into the dirty areas, and really make you work for that puck when you want it.
Of course, Matt, we look at the keys to the game. Both of these teams, two very good teams. They know their opponents very well. What do these teams need to do to come away with a victory?
Well, we talked about it similarly to Cornell. With St. Lawrence, you have to shut down their power play. Cornell had a great one, and they made the Knights pay twice. St. Lawrence has one of the top power plays, the top power play in the country, converting at a near 29%. Really excellent on the power play. And for St. Lawrence, you have to control the pace. You know you're going to push, and you know Clarkson's going to try to counter and transition you. How are you going to respond to that, and how are you going to be able to keep this game at a pace that suits you instead of the slightly slower pace that Clarkson's going to try to bring it down to use some of their bigger bodies to their advantage?
Now starting with the starting lineup of the SLU Saints. Of course, many Saints fans in the building getting a bit of an earful from the Cheel faithful here. At left defense, number 2, Eric Sweetman, a freshman from Woodbine, Maryland. at right defense, number 51, the senior from Toronto, Justin Baker. He's got a thunderous slap shot from the point on the power play with 16 points on the season. At left wing, number 10, Greg Carey. Watch out for him. 29 points this season through 16 games. The center, his brother, Matt Carey, also from Hamilton, Ontario. He's himself has 19 points this season through 16 games in his freshman campaign. And the right wing of that line, number 25, Chris Martin, also pretty productive. That top line really getting things done for the Saints. And in net, really hadn't been the most stellar performance for him this year. Number 34, Matt Weninger out of Lethbridge, Alberta.
Well, you know, Matt Weninger, only one win in his career the last 3 years against Clarkson. Clarkson has certainly had the Saints' number as of recent. Casey Jones' record, 7-1-1 against the Knights in his 3 years. Certainly looking to add to that with another W here tonight. Getting the start on defense, it's going to be the sophomore duo once again. Net number at left defense, going to be number 3, the sophomore, Paul Geiger. At right defense, you know he's going to be happy to get back into this rivalry. Number 10, sophomore defenseman, Kevin Tansey. At left wing, going with number 20, the senior, Jarrett Burton. Centering this top line for the Knights, going to be number 14, the captain, the 09 draft pick of the Boston Bruins, Ben Sexton. And at right wing, it's going to be the scorer for this line, number 27, the junior, Joe Zarbo. And in a goal, it's going to be number 33, Greg Lewis, getting the start in this big game. He has been stellar all year for the Knights, has a great record against St. Lawrence, really shows up to play for this rivalry more than usual.
And Matt, watch out for this fourth line of the Knights with Matt Zarbo, Will Frederick, and Simone Bissett. Frederick has the nickname the Slew Slayer. Matt Zarbo, of course, getting 33% of his goals in his career coming against this St. Lawrence team. And Simone Bissett with 4 goals last year in the three matchups that they had. But before any of that could take place, we'll have to take it down to the national anthems. Presenting the colors is the Army ROTC Color Guard.
And Matt, just like that, Cheel Arena has filled to capacity
signs on the door when you walked in said standing room tickets only. They sold out about 3 weeks ago for this game. Huge crowd always here at Cheel Arena. Last year crammed the record high people in this building at 4,125 crazy fans.
And I'm pretty sure they're going to be pushing that again here tonight. You can see the pep band all dressed in gold. Clarkson University supplying some pretty nice gold t-shirts for the pep banders as they're ready. The fans are ready. And I think we're about ready for this to get going. We've been looking forward to this matchup all year. Now with Clarkson in the top 10, trying to push to move up, and St. Lawrence just on the outside, somewhere in the 25-ish range, trying to show that they deserve to belong into that top 20 in the nation.
Of course, looking at the two goaltenders we'll see here tonight, looking first at Matt Wenninger of St. Lawrence, coming through 15 games, holding a 6-5-2 record with a 3.41 goals against and 0.875 save percentage. And on the other end of the ice, they'll be staring at him all night, Greg Lewis, 7-2-0. Pretty good goals against average for Greg, really dropped that number down since last season, 2.11. Of course, neither of these goaltenders having a shutout so far this season. And as we mentioned, SLU not really holding on to a lot of games. Really, the games they have won have been pretty high scoring, seeing a lot of 6-4, 6-5 games from St. Lawrence. Really one of those teams that thinks that the best defense sometimes is to have a potent offense, and they certainly have that. The Knights, though, more of a traditionally defensive team, a big D-core back on the back end. Very experienced D-core as well with all these guys playing together with the addition of James DeHaas this year, a guy who's very capable, and we are underway in the North Country rivalry. The battle of Route 11 has begun as this one comes back for Sweetman. Sweetman will carry this one, getting his first taste of the rivalry ahead for Martin. Martin got a piece of it into the Knight zone. Lewis will slow it down for Tansy. Tansy, one of those players anxious to get back into the swing of things here with the SLU Clarkson game. We saw him blowing up Twitter earlier this week. This one back for Baker, holding there, got Burton to fan on it. Burton, though, will swipe it away. After this one now is Tansy. He'll take body in the corner, back for Sexton. Tansy lost his man there. Baker coming back up with the puck, falling down at the same time. And Martin now shoulders off Zarbo. In comes Sexton. Sexton back for Zarbo. Zarbo loses it there as he's taken off by Baker. And now Martin will turn this one ahead for St. Lawrence. Dumped ahead. Sweetman finds that one. He'll throw it in and around the Knight zone. After here is Geiger. Finding it there is Howden as well, as Howden will hold, trying to get some help there from Geiger. Battling in the corner there from Ward. Swung back out to the point. That one going past McMullen. And now after it, here is McGinnity. McGinnity got the wheels going. Shot from McGinnity. Save Wenninger. That one not from the best angle, but it'll count for the first shot of the night. Denalo finding this one in front from McGinnity. That one just wide. Pat McGinnity with an excellent chance on the feed from Denalo. And we mentioned Denalo with that big game. He's been moved up to this second line with the high-scoring McPherson and McGinnity. LeBrec now pinching down on this one. McMullen will play that one out, and Denalo throwing the body there. Ward gaining the blue line, holds. And I believe offside was called, and Ward still fired that one. Denalo not happy. The linesman, though, will break things up before it gets too rowdy.
Clarkson with the first really great chance of the game. First coming off the stick of Pat McGinnity as he was able to beat the St. Lawrence defender back to the puck and then fire off a bad angle shot, but he was able to make Matt Wenninger at least to make a save. A good job, though, working that puck then down low by Jeff Denalo. We saw him do it early on in that Cornell game. Got it in front. That time it was to Al McPherson. Here tonight he gets it to McGinnity, who just misses on the one-time opportunity.
Wick tried to deflect that one in. Wick out with Essery, the captain and assistant captain of the St. Lawrence Guard. Two experienced seniors as Essery tries to work that one free for Moore. This one will be picked up by Rally. Back to the near side for Bayreuther. And Bayreuther will get this one back. Ahead finds Essery, and Essery now across the blue line. Try to get that one up ahead there for Hagen. DeHaas now will retreat after this one. DeHaas with a little bit different look. Got that haircut over Thanksgiving break. Really chopped off the luscious locks that he had going out of the helmet. I believe the players call it the flow mat. This one, though, after it is Howden playing ahead for Boak. Got a piece of it. Not enough to get it through the neutral zone. And this one gloved back down by Boak at his own blue line. Chasing after this one now is McGovern putting on the pressure, taking out Boak in the corner. And Matt Zarbo going back down now. Hudson tied up with Boak. McGovern will find this one now. Still trying to work it free there from Howden. Holding on to this one now is Hudson. Still working down low are the Saints. And now coming in to join the fray there is Matt Zarbo. taking down Hudson in the corner. Broken stick on the play. I believe that's Howden's, as he's just going to stick with his man Hudson along the boards. Going down there was Dahl. Frederick still trying to clear it out. As this one tossed back in by McGovern. Gloved down by Howden, and he'll soccer kick that one out of the zone. New twig waiting for him as he gets back to the bench. Tossed that one back in was Matt Zarbo, and after it here is Bissett. Quick shot from Bissett, and that one wide of the net. Scooping it off the boards there was Tansy. Had to delay to get it away from Carey, and I believe offside going to be called on the Knights.
Good play there by James Howden, playing without one of the most important pieces of equipment out there, the hockey stick. Caught that one, threw it down, and was able to kick it up to Simone Bissett, able to get Clarkson out of the zone, get himself a new piece of lumber to play with. But as you mentioned, that one just offside is Kevin Tansy. It looked like that puck hooked up on his stick and wasn't able to control it. Had to play it back in past Greg Carey. Simone Bissett touching it offside. The referee now coming over. Just some friendly words of encouragement there between Jared Burton and Chris Martin.
Playing this one ahead, getting a piece of it there was Matt Carey. Greg Carey leveled there by Kevin Tansy, and that'll get the Cheel faithful going. Student section knowing the appreciation there. Sent back across there by Matt. Shot by Sweetman, deflected, and that one going wide. Geiger getting to it along the boards. Picked up here. Now back to Greg Carey. Potent line out, and that one goes wide. Carey fires his first of the night. Back now to Martin. Greg Carey posting up in front. He is covered by both of those Clarkson defenders there. Toss in front. Sweetman got a piece of that one, though, was Burton, I believe. As Geiger will find this one along the boards, holding now, carries across the blue line, has Burton as well. He'll dump that one in on Wenninger, and Wenninger will use the blocker to sear that one aside. Baker will take a hit down low from Sexton, who give him that as he heads off the ice. LeBrec now trying to sweep, but that one Ward in, getting around Howden, shot in that one over the blocker of Lewis, off the glass and out into the zone. Hughes and McPherson will exchange blows. This one picked up by Doherty. He'll chase it down on the near side, still trying to work this one free. Back to Austin. Austin swinging that one to the far side. Gets it to McMullen. McMullen now back in the zone. Stop there, and McPherson will hold. Still trying to work it free. Out by Howden, and Denalo steps into his man along the board. Scooped up by McGinnity. McGinnity up ahead across for McPherson. Now racing after this one. Getting the feet going is the speedy Al McPherson. Trying to work that one free from McGovern. McMullen now shoving off McPherson. Back for Denalo, and that one just wide. That one had some velocity on it, Matt. Boak steers that one in front. McPherson with the puck in front. Denalo now holding it back for DeHaas. Shot wide of the net. After this one now, Hughes avoids that collision with Denalo. Saw it coming as Denalo had him in the sights. And now chasing after this one as it slowed down behind the net is Lewis.
We talked about the women's team capitalizing on their chances in their game earlier with North Dakota. Tonight, the men's team with a flurry here to start the game. They've had many good chances, but a couple have just gone wide of the net. Most recently, that shot from James DeHaas. He missed one. So did Jeff Denalo earlier.
And Fossen gets that icing waved off. Excellent play by him down low. Moore now shaking off a hit from Bayreuther in the corner. Still trying to work this one free. Bayreuther will come up with it. Carries that one into his own zone. Holds. Fossen thought. And a big hit there by Geiger on Hagen. And Geiger's going to have to pay the price for that one. He's probably going to get two for an interference. So Geiger headed to the box. Clean hit. Could question that it was interference. Nonetheless, he'll be headed. And, of course, the fans here at Cheel not in agreement with the referee.
Paul Geiger there just a second too early to make that check. He was trying to take out his man. And as that guy, the St. Lawrence player, was trying to deflect that one into the zone. Geiger stepping up smartly, but just there too early, takes down his man. And now the St. Lawrence power play gets its first opportunity. They're very good. We talked about them being first in the nation. Clarkson's going to have their hands full here tonight if they give the Saints too many penalties.
Matt Carey now will hold. Delays. Gets Howden down as well as Burton, and Sexton now shoves his man off. Boak getting there. Still trying to work it free there from Greg Carey. Taken down by Boak in the corner. Boak losing a stick and a shot held there by Lewis. Watch out for Jeremy Wick. He likes to be the trigger man on this power play. Leads the team in those power play goals category.
Very dangerous line out there for St. Lawrence. Matt Carey centering. Greg Carey, you already talked about him. Jeremy Wick, the senior assistant captain, wearing number 19. Out there along with Justin Baker, who's having himself a pretty good year. 16 points through 16 games. He also likes to operate on the power play. St. Lawrence, a lot of good offensive players. The Knights are going to have to be very good on the penalty kill if they give up too many opportunities to the Saints.
Boak doing job, good job to get that one 200 feet down the length of the ice. Bayreuth now ahead for Baker. Now to Greg Carey. Stepping in. Carey trying to get around Tansy. Dropped it off for Matt. Matt will play it back around. Picked up now by Greg. Greg Carey getting around Tansy. Sends it back to the point. Baker now swings it to the other side for Bayreuther. Now back to Baker. Back to the far side for Greg Carey. Move back down low for Matt Carey. Shot there. Save. Score. Jeremy Wick. Another power play goal for him. He'll add one more to his total on the year.
Very good puck movement by the Saints. Frees up Jeremy Wick to find that rebound in front. Greg Carey dished it off to his brother down low, who threw it in front. Had a couple of whacks at it before Jeremy Wick could finally dish that one into the back of the net. St. Lawrence with an early power play tally. That shows you just what you can't do against the Saints. Saw Clarkson do it against Cornell. Both their goals in that game came on the power play. So far, St. Lawrence 1-for-1 on the power play. And they've got that first goal on the board.
Joseph's unable to win that one back as it came back to Sweetman. Played back in. Holding now is Gunnar Hughes. Hughes sends that one back around behind the net of Lewis. Tied up with his man there is Geiger looking for a penalty. Joseph's now out for the first shift, trying to throw a body, get a taste of what it's like to be out there against the Saints. Moore finds this one, tried to feed it off the boards. Doherty, though, deflected it. Big hit there from Tansy on Ward. Back out in front, that one will slide. Kept in there nicely by the Saints. Sweetman back across, getting that one across for Ward. Ward with a shot, that one going wide of the net. After this is Doherty, he'll hold in the corner. Spinning off this one, back in front for Ward, working it down low there for Hughes. Hughes now throwing on the brakes, losing Josephs. Couldn't get it back to Ward, and Ward pestered by Geiger. Back now to Hughes, across now for Sweetman. That one goes through his legs. Moore kicking it ahead, and Moore now trying to get in on a breakaway. Tied up there with Riley as well, and Fawson will throw a hit there on Sweetman. Held now by Doherty. He'll wrap it around the boards. After here is Dahl. Dahl met there by DeHaas as well. And that one played off the glass by Frederick, dropping down and stopped there. Austin will hold now for St. Lawrence. Pestered by Frederick, swung across for McMullen, and now up ahead getting that one there for McGovern. He's met by Boak. And now Hudson trying to get to work, trying to find a way around James DeHaas. DeHaas trying to keep up with his man as this one will slide out of the night zone, and the Saints seem to be putting a lot of offensive pressure here early, Matt.
Well, they're doing a very good job of cycling that puck down low, taking advantage fact that Clarkson has some of those bigger bodies. You know, if they're going to get you along those boards, they're going to take you down and hold you up and not allow you to work. St. Lawrence has done a very good job using their speed and skill to keep the bigger Clarkson defense off of their players.
Taking a stick up high there was Matt Zarbo. Maybe a high stick going to be called here as the ref's arm's in the air. Shot there. That one going just wide on the wraparound attempt. Bissett will get to this one in the corner. Still trying to work it free. Finding it there was Matt Zarbo. Shot and held by Wenninger. Bissett now heading back to the bench to get a stick. Penalty going to be called, though. It's going to be a high stick, and it's going to be coming on, an elbowing, and it's going to be coming on number 23, Riley Austin. So the Knights have their first chance on the power play for the evening.
High stick or elbowing. Austin gets his arms and stick up into the face. I believe it was Will Frederick down low in the corner. Frederick snapping his head back as Austin really got up there and gave him a shot right to the face. Now Clarkson onto the power play of their own. They've been about average so far this year, but in these big kind of games, you have to step up and be very good on the power play. St. Lawrence has already capitalized on their chance. Clarkson wants to win, so they're going to have to capitalize on their chances on the power play as well.
Holding here is Geiger. He's been pretty good on this night's power play. More seeing time on the power play unit again. Is this one back to Sexton now for Zarbo. Shot deflected up into the glass by Wenninger. A little bit different looking unit we see from the Knights than what we're seeing here right now. Still trying to work this one free, and Sexton and Wick tied up there. Still trying to work it free is Moore, and Wick doing a good job after it now is Joe Zarbo. Still trying to work this one free there from Sweetman. Esri will blast that one off the back of the referee's helmet, I believe. It's this one comes to Tansy, worked around for Geiger. Geiger now back to Sexton. Sexton holding here. Tansy making the run in front, going hard to the net. Holding here is Zarbo. Shot delayed there. They score. TJ Moore gets his first of the year.
And it looked like Essery just trying to get out of the way in frustration after the Knights score, but TJ Moore able to give the Knights their first on the power play as well. A nice play by Ben Sexton to feed TJ Moore down low. more able to throw that one in front, was trying to get it across to Kevin Tanzi. I believe it went off one of the St. Lawrence defenders in front, goes past the line. So just like that, Clarkson answers with their own power play goal to tie this game at one apiece with 10:32 left in the first period.
And if you're TJ Moore, that one's got to feel good. Been on of a scoring drought there for the sophomore, and a little bit of a slump racing after this one, though, is LeBrec. He'll get his first of the year, and what a better team to do it against than St. Lawrence here at home. McPherson was racing ahead with that one. I believe offside going to be called as McPherson got there just ahead of the puck as it was poked away right as he got to the blue line.
Nice poke check by Gavin Bayreuther, the freshman. Al McPherson trying to come up with speed. Bayreuther using that long reach, standing 6'1", able to poke that one off the stick and force Al McPherson offsides. TJ Moore rewards Casey Jones for a little trust, putting him on that first power play. You mentioned it, that's TJ Moore's first of the year, only his third point, but a good thing for the sophomore, step up in this big rivalry game and get Clarkson on the board.
And now Hughes and Howden are going to exchange some words there. Hughes going to smartly make his way back to the bench after shaving Greg Lewis with a nice snow bath. Of course, those two have been looking at each other eye to eye for 3 years now, or 2 years, this would be the third. But guys who know this rivalry. Also saw Jeff Dinallo out there exchanging some words with Matt Carey. So really, these two teams have certainly some displeasantries for each other. But this one's going to be played back in by St. Lawrence. Trying to feed that one back in front was Matt Carey. He'll give a shove to Joe Zarbo there. And after this one is Frederick, picked up there by Sweetman. Sweetman has a stripped away by Matt Zarbo. That one tossed back in, and after it now is Bissett. Bissett throwing a hit there on Baker, who goes down in the corner. Holding there is Matt Carey ahead for Greg. Greg now working this one, trying to get around Bissett ahead for Martin. Martin met by Tanzi. Drops it back off there for Greg Carey. He'll take a hit from Frederick as well. Held by Tanzi around for Frederick. Frederick holding onto this one now. Ahead off the glove of Baker, and after it now is Bissett. Swatting at this one as it's picked up here by McMullen. He'll lose an edge behind his own end line. Ahead gets that one to Hudson, and Hudson now trying to get around Boak. Hudson and Boak tied up down there, and Boak clearing it out there to Joe Zarbo. Tried to feed it off the boards there for Sexton, unable to do so. Big turnover there. Hudson with a shot held by Lewis. And going hard to the net there was Dahl and DeHaas and Boak. Going to show that they're not going to let anybody go at the goaltenders here this evening. Of course, we've seen Clarkson a couple times now really coming to the aid of Greg Lewis, not really letting any sort of after-play activities occur.
Well, good job there by the referee not calling a penalty as Dahl really was driving hard to the net, realizing the defense. And, I mean, when you think about it, that was a pretty gentle takedown for Alex Boak as Dahl came to the net hard. Boak trying to keep it under control here early. We know St. Lawrence is good on the power play. The last thing Clarkson needs right now is to give them another opportunity with the man advantage.
Still trying to hold on to this one was Joe Zarbo, stripped away and carried ahead by McGovern. McGovern now playing onto this one, gets it back here. I believe offside is the call.
I'm going to bring that one all the way back down to the St. Lawrence end, just outside of their own offensive zone, as that one was a delayed offsides that St. Lawrence didn't realize was an offsides call and kept pressuring up along the boards. Clarkson going to send out Troy Joseph's line that, of course, has TJ Moore on it, the Clarkson goal scorer.
Holding on to this one, playing ahead is Rally, picked up by Fawson, and he'll start it the other way. After this one now is Joseph's. Joseph's after this one trying to work free from Rally. Moore now battling there against Esri as well. Is this one picked up by Bayreuther. Bayreuther seeing some time here as a freshman. Joseph's with an attempt, and that backhand goes over the net. Tipped there, I believe, by the defender. Now after this one is Fawson. Wick will fish it off the boards. Coming to this one now here and lift it up and out of play. That one off the stick of Rally. So this will stay in the St. Lawrence zone just to the left of Matt Wenninger.
Couple of near giveaways there for the Knights.
And bringing back some old school tradition is the Clarkson Pep Band. A couple friends found the signs in Pep Band storage. Decided they'd break it out for the St. Lawrence game. What a better time to get the fans here at Cheel going.
And, I mean, it's not like the Clarkson Pep Band needed an excuse to get going for this game.
Babe Ruther will get this one back. He'll throw it back around behind his own net. Fishing it off the boards. There is Wick. Wick starting ahead. He's got Esri with him as well as the sophomore Alex Hagan. Finding it here now is Esri still trying to work free from McPherson. Able to strip that puck away. Plays it back around for LeBrec. LeBrec getting his feet going. Ahead for Denalo. Sweetman, though, breaking it up nicely there. I believe two men are going to be called on the Saints as the door was open. Having a hard time getting into the bench there was Esri. Too many going to be called every time. And going to serve this one, I believe, is going to be Doherty. He looked like he was hopping out, not sure exactly who.
And Baker was the extra guy out there on the ice. He's actually the man that made the stop on that breakout pass to Jeff Denalo. I believe it was Raleigh had not gotten into the bench yet. Was slow to get off on that change, so Baker forced to play that puck. Now Clarkson with another opportunity on the power play, already capitalizing on one. See if they can't make it 2-for-2.
So Matt Carroll will serve that one in the box for SLU. Trying to find this one now and breaking out of the zone is Doherty. Getting some speed. Gets that one past Geiger. And now after it here is Tansy. He'll get it after Lewis plays that one behind his own net. Carrying this one ahead. Geiger will lift it in the zone. So the bench minor coming on SLU. Knights on the power play now as Baker will hold on to that one, lifting it up and down the length of the ice, stopped by Lewis.
Clarkson going to switch it up, go with the first power play unit, as that second power play unit just couldn't really break into the zone effectively. Of course, Sam LeBrec out there, he likes to fire lasers. Saw him get one in that Queens University game. See if he can't get another one here.
That one cleared out of the zone again by the Saints. Denala was taken down in front of the net there on that last rush. And in that Queens game, Matt, Sam LeBrec with a goal that we usually don't see from him. Not necessarily a laser from the point, but a nice play breaking down in for a quick one-timer as Denalo going hard to the net. Almost paid the price on the corner there. Denalo will get this one back, swing it back in there for McPherson, who's taken down by a hard hit there from Baker. Going down as well was Denalo. That one cleared down the length of the ice again, and Denalo will retrieve his piece of lumber. Head back to the bench. Just 30 seconds left for the Knights on the power play.
Unlike on that first power play where Clarkson was able to capitalize, they haven't been able to break in very effectively here against the Saints. It looks like they've just gotten to the line and they've stopped. Kind of like that from Kevin Tansy. All that momentum coming down the ice just sort of gets killed right there at the blue line. And it's really hard for those guys to get back in, get on that puck quick, and force St. Lawrence to turn it over to you on the power play. And now Clarkson going to be denied a change after looked like they were trying to get that fourth line out with just 17 seconds left. Now because of the delay, Ben Sexton going to be thrown out of the faceoff. TJ Moore stepping in to try to win it.
This one stopped by Lewis. Excuse me, Lewis will leave it. Thought about stopping that one. Left it there for Geiger. Now the Knights are going to make sure they get the right offensive personnel out that they wanted. Carrying this one ahead now is Matt Zarbo, weaving through traffic, gets that one ahead. Bissett will play it back in for Matt Zarbo, back for Bissett. Bissett walking in, loose puck there, sitting at the side of the net, chipped up by Frederick, and they score! And Wenninger absolutely livid on that one. Referees, I guarantee, going to be taking a look at that one in the replay booth. That one's either going to Bissett or Frederick. And this fourth line that Casey Jones has put together really has had St. Lawrence's number. And now Baker over there giving an earful to the referee.
Well, from what I saw, it looked like that was, well, first a nice play by Matt Zarbo to hustle into the zone. Simone Bissett pushes it down there to him, gets a return pass, and goes hard to the net. That's where that play starts. Then it's a good job by Will Frederick to crash. It looked like, to me, he chipped it up over the pad of Wenninger. Might have hit him in the back and fallen in. From where we were after that point, it looked like just a massive body swarming the St. Lawrence net. Couldn't really get a good view of what was going on. Hopefully the referees can, with the replays they have over the top of the nets, and can figure out if that is or is not a good Clarkson goal.
And, of course, that puck I could see sitting right here at the side of the post when Will Frederick got a piece of it sitting next to the skate. Good goal. And Baker, in an outrage, agreed. Will Frederick looked like he got that one. And I think St. Lawrence's biggest problem was that at the end of that play, Matt Wenninger was in the back of his own net.
And I think that's what Baker's trying to argue here with the referee, is that Wenninger, because there were so many Clarkson players in there pushing that puck, one of them probably pushed Wenninger in. I'm going to assume that the puck was in before Wenninger got pushed into the net. We didn't get a great look at it. All he knows, the referees got to do it, and they're the guys that get paid to make those kinds of calls.
After this one now is LeBrecq. LeBrecq will find it in his own zone, still trying to work free from Matt Carey. So that one coming just after the power play for the Knights had ended. So 5-on-5 tally for Clarkson. Finding this one here is Bissett trying to play that one ahead. Frederick will chase it down. Frederick getting to that one, play it in. Harsh treatment there from Austin. Is this one picked up and carried ahead by Carey? Getting that one ahead for Greg Carey, and now retreating out of the zone. Icing going to be called on the Saints. So Bissett going to get credit for that goal. And Tansy going to get an assist as well. And Matt Zarbo going to be the secondary assist on that goal. So Will Frederick really not getting anything on that one. Really looked like he would probably be the head guy on that for either a goal or an assist. So no play, no points there for Will Frederick. Nonetheless, the Saints with a flurry of opportunities here as Bayreuther will send that one back across for Rally. Now back to Rally. Shot through traffic. That one wide of the net. After it here, Bayreuther will play it back around. Stopped though and held by LeBrecq. Played with a high stick. And this one will stay in the Clarkson zone.
Clarkson is going to be able to change though after that icing had one that had been out there for quite some time. Sam LeBrecq and James Howden in particular, the defense had been out there. But they will get the change along Troy Joseph's line to come out. A.J. Fawson and T.J. Moore flanking him on the wings. Alex Boak and James DeHaas also out there for the Knights.
Still trying to play this one ahead is Josephs. Icing waved off as Josephs will chase this one down, looking to put the hit there on Sweetman. Does one thing that notice from Troy Josephs, one of those guys who is going to finish his check no matter what. On the forecheck, on the back check, Troy Josephs finishes his checks. He'll get around there. Nifty move to avoid that collision with Sweetman, who wanted some revenge. As Boston will take his man into the boards. Baker not really pleased with that, looking for some help from the officials. And DeHaas, knowing he was offside, will hold up on that one.
James DeHaas, the guilty party, unable to get to that one. Just about 2 inches out of the line. You could just barely see some white space before he got to that one. Another turnover by St. Lawrence in their own zone. They've had a couple here. It hasn't cost them too much, but if you continue to give chances to a team, you know they're eventually going to be able to get you one. And if Clarkson continues to put pressure and force those turnovers, it could end up badly for the Saints.
Picked up by Doherty. Doherty will launch that one into the Knight zone, slowed down by Lewis. Playing that one, and Doherty will be the first one to it. Can't pull the trigger, though, was Hughes. Picked up here now and carried ahead by Joe Zarbo, trying to work this one back around. So Joe Zarbo, the lone Zarbo brother, and a tabletop here. That Austin getting a piece of Sexton, and Sexton not really pleased with that. Holding now is Geiger. And really, Matt, we mentioned that the Saints need to control the pace of this game if they want to really come away with a victory. It seems like Clarkson has been controlling the pace so far through the first 17 or so minutes of this first period.
Well, I think St. Lawrence came out at the beginning of that period, and they looked a little flat-footed as Clarkson had 3 or 4 good minutes of zone control. And the next 3 or 4 really was dominated by the Saints. They were finally able to get that first line going, cycling that puck down low. But ever since Clarkson's been able to get on the board at that 10-minute mark, they've really done a great job of continuing to put pressure on St. Lawrence. They're able to get that second goal. Really, they've done a good job in the last 10 minutes of this first period to control the pace themselves, not allow St. Lawrence as much room, as much space. St. Lawrence seems a little bit frustrated about the Knights putting the body on them down low and in the corners.
Tansy poking that one away there. Unable to do much with it was Baker as he'll wrap it back around, getting it there. A big hit from Sexton there on Matt Carey. And Greg Carey will find himself with this in the neutral zone. Shoved off the puck there by Sexton. Picked up by Matt Carey. He's taken down on the play. now picked up by Tansy. And I think the message that Casey Jones has put out for his team is the line with the Carey brothers. Don't give them any inch of space. Be right in their hip side pocket. Throw the body on them. Get them irritated. Get them off their game. And we'll see what happens. Shot from McPherson as that one's covered by Wininger.
A weak shot there from Allen McPherson, but a good job nonetheless to control that puck with a man right on him. Get it towards the net. Wininger couldn't cover it there for a second, but a good job by St. Lawrence covering their men in front, not allowing any free bodies in front of that net, looking to find that rebound off the Al McPherson shot.
Holding is Bayreuther. Bayreuther delaying here, sending it back around, getting that one to Rally. Rally now back to Bayreuther, and Bayreuther will wrap that one a little bit more for McGovern. McGovern sending it right back around for Rally. Rally met there by Denalo. Saw that one coming as you could tell Denalo had lined up Rally. McPherson now holding onto this one, trying to drag it around himself. Picked up there by Rally, lifted up and out of the zone. Stopped by DeHaas. DeHaas sending this one back from McGinnity, and McGinnity back into the St. Lawrence zone. Rally will hold there, up and out of the zone ahead, finding McGovern. McGovern questionably offside there, gloved down by DeHaas, trying to work that one free. Picked up now by McGovern, back across there for Hudson. Hudson trying to make the move around one, and McGovern met by Boak. Hudson going down at the same time behind the net, drawing both Clarkson defenders as well. Penalty coming up to to Clarkson. And it's going to be a hit from behind. Going to have to see who this one's going to be on.
It's going to be on Troy Josephs as he took down his man in front. I certainly don't agree with that call, as it looked like number 12 McGovern went down pretty easily in front. Josephs just trying to move him out of the way in front of the net as Hudson was trying to find him in front with a pass. McGovern goes down. Troy Josephs goes off. 2 minutes for the hit from behind. So 1:31 left in this first period. St. Lawrence now with an opportunity to capitalize again on the power play.
Bayreuther across. Get that one to Baker. Baker shooting that one towards the net. Picked up here by Wick. Sent back around. Held there by Matt Carey. Matt Carey had that one stripped away there from Tansy. Bayreuther now will hold on to this one to the near side for Baker. Baker up ahead. Gets that one to Matt Carey. He will carry this one in. Carey across there for Bayreuther. Now dropped off for Greg Carey. Now back to Bayreuther. Got a piece of it, enough to send it towards Baker. Baker now has it stripped away there. Sexton still battling along the boards. Geiger coming in to join as well. And Sexton still down on the ice there. Picked up Greg Carey. Fires that one wide. Getting over to cover on that one as that one's attempted to be lifted out. Back across for Baker, and that one going just wide. Trying to get there was Geiger. Holding now by Matt Carey. Back around for Greg. Now to Bayreuther. Bayreuther looked to tee that one up. Held up on it, though. Now back to Baker. Baker holding. Back in front for Wick. That one poked away by Burton. Excellent job to deny that chance on the back door. Back for Bayreuther. Shot, and they score. Gavin Bayreuther sneaks that one past Greg Lewis on the far side. And the Saints have their second power play goal of the night in just as many power plays.
Wick doing a great job working in front of Greg Lewis. It didn't look like he saw that shot until it might have already been past him. A good screen in front by Wick, the power play specialist for the St. Lawrence team. And once again, St. Lawrence capitalizes on the power play. We talked about it as one of their big goals coming into this game. If you give them a chance on the power play, they capitalize on almost 30%, right up around 28.7% of their power plays. You can't give them chances, and if you do, they're going to score.
Sweetman's shot blocked by Boak, carrying this one ahead, unable to drag it with him was Denalo, as Lewis will slow that one down. Howden will get there in time, look up, take a glance, just look to kill the rest of this one off. So at the end of the first, these two teams knotted up at 2 goals apiece. The North Country rivalry is flourishing. We'll see what happens. We'll get you back for a quick intermission report. Stay tuned here on WCKN.
foods to the right temperature using a food thermometer. 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
If you're looking for a new pet that your family will cherish every day, consider adopting from a shelter. Shelters are the best places to find a new pet. That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals, eager to become a part of your family. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. So bring home your new buddy today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
Come into Great Northern Printing today, your source for official licensed Clarkson University merchandise and all your custom screen printing and embroidery needs. Stop by their showroom and see how they can help you. Located at 6 Main Street in Potsdam, across from the Clarkson Inn.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back here inside Cheel Arena. Still knotted up 2-2 between the Knights and the Saints. The Battle of Route 11 was a pretty physical one there in the first period, Matt. Two teams came out looking to play, pretty fired up, and we saw some pretty good hockey in that first period. Of course, the Saints getting both of their goals on the power play. The Knights getting one of their goals on the power play and one shortly after. So really, the story so far has been it's costing teams to go to the penalty box. So really, it's been pretty back and forth, some physicality, and really the tempers have started to flare.
Yeah, both these teams, you can certainly see they're not, you know, the best of friends out there on the ice. Both teams know not only is this a rivalry, but both teams really could use a good win here tonight, especially going back to St. Lawrence tomorrow. There's a lot of pressure on Clarkson to at least take the home series of this game, and then both teams trying to at least get their home wins. St. Lawrence trying to come out tonight, see if they can't take an away win away from Clarkson, especially with Clarkson so highly ranked. St. Lawrence right on the cusp of getting ranked. A win against a top 10 team can really push you up in the rankings, something I'm sure St. Lawrence is looking to get to.
Of course, St. Lawrence tallied first on the power play. We saw some good puck movement from the Saints. Really did a really good job here. And Jeremy Wick, just being that trigger man, found it in front, put it in the back of the net, just parked right in front, loose puck at the top of the crease. Not much Greg Lewis can do about that. And Wick adding to his total. He leads that team in power play goals. So Jeremy Wick really doing some good things for the Saints. You'll see why he wears that A for the assistant captain, and really just an emotional leader and a leader on and off the ice for the Saints team.
And certainly for him to come out, get that first big goal on the power play, able to capitalize on the Clarkson mistake, a great start to this game for St. Lawrence, and we've seen how good they can be on the power play all year. They've already hurt the Knights with two. That was the first, and it got them off to a pretty good start to start off this game.
And of course, TJ Moore ended his scoring drought with a power play goal of his own. Sexton tried to feed it in front for Tansy, who looked to be crashing pretty hard to the net. Moore found himself with it. Nice little wraparound attempt there. And of course, we saw Kyle Esri get kind of tangled up in that nice celebration, just trying to get out of the way. And of course, in a game against St. Lawrence, tempers flare. You don't want anybody from the opposite team in the middle of your celebration huddle. So Esri had to pay the price there on that one. But then Clarkson coming back. Good play at the end of another power play. Matt Zarbo chipping it into the zone, going out of the net. And then Bissett walking in hard. Loose puck there, chipped up. A couple players poking out of that one. Back went in the back of the net. SLU not really happy with how it all went down. And we saw the assistant captain, Justin Baker, really giving an earful to the referees. They went and reviewed it. Goal stood. Weninger was still upset with the call as well. And then, of course, we saw St. Lawrence come back, Matt, with that second power play goal.
Yeah, a good job by St. Lawrence to again capitalize on the power play. They've really made Clarkson pay on the power play opportunities. That time, Bayreuther just fires off. Not the best slap shot, but a good slap shot. He gets it through traffic. Wick standing in front. Looked like Greg Lewis, a little handcuffed as it got towards him. You'd like to see Greg Lewis make that save, but through some of that traffic, it's always hard for the goaltenders to find those pucks. Lewis has done a good job, though, as St. Lawrence has moved that puck around quite a bit on the power play. A lot of crisp passing for them. They've been moving that puck from tape to tape, and it's been hard for Clarkson to keep up. But Greg Lewis so far has done a good job on the power play. Keep making a few saves, hasn't made them all, but you got to make sure you keep with your man on the power play.
Of course, Bayreuther's slap shot may not be the hardest one, Matt, but had that thing going about a half an inch more to the right, it would have gone off the post. He really snuck that one right in that right upright, and really not much Greg Lewis could have done about it. You'd like to see him make a save. Fortunately, couldn't with the traffic in front, but both these teams playing pretty well. Both the teams firing offensively. If you're Clarkson, you don't want to let this game turn into run and gun, because you're going to lose that one to this very potent offense with St. Lawrence. So what do both these teams need to do to kind of limit that from happening and control the game and control their own destiny?
Well, we talked about it already a little bit. Both of these teams in this second period have to stay out of the box. Clarkson has already given up two power play goals. St. Lawrence has given up one on two of the opportunities for the Knights. So far, there's been three in total of the four scored. And you know, if you're Clarkson, if you keep giving St. Lawrence opportunities, you're just letting them get back into this game, because we know even if they don't score, they're going to get their chances. They're going to force Greg Lewis to make some really good saves. They're going to keep your best players off the ice, some of your best offensive players who don't play on the PK. So if you're St. Lawrence or Clarkson, you have to stay out of the box. And it's hard when some of these games, especially these big rivalries when emotions are high, to make sure you don't take those dumb penalties after the whistle. It's always hard, but you got to stay disciplined here in the rest of the game.
So we'll see if the parade to the penalty box continues and which team will control their own destiny. Find out that much more as we get you back for the start of the second. Stay tuned on WCKN. Welcome back to Potsdam, New York. Cheel Arena is the site. The Saints and the Knights in a good one so far. Let's take a look at those period stats from the first period of play. As you can see, all knotted up at two goals apiece. Clarkson out shooting the Saints, and Matt Winninger with seven saves. Two saves for Greg Lewis of Clarkson. And right now, St. Lawrence winning the battle in the faceoff dart. Clarkson coming into this game number one in the country and far of in terms of winning faceoffs at 55.3%. And of course, both these teams taking those two penalties, SLU capitalizing on both of them, and Clarkson capitalizing on one, getting their second goal shortly after the other. So really, that has been the story so far. But Matt, crazy thing is, a lot of these freshmen coming in, the likes of AJ Fawson, Troy Josephs, and a couple of the other guys coming in on the Clarkson roster, recruited by St. Lawrence as well. So really, at the end of this game, maybe you'll see some players from either team questioning why they chose which school they did, maybe wondering if it would have been the other way had they chosen the other school. Who knows? What's done is done. Both of these teams now dedicated to one side of this rivalry as we are underway now in the second period. Leading the charge ahead now is Matt Carey. Drops it off from Martin. Martin clear into the zone. Back for Matt Carey. Had it poked away. Finding it here is Sexton. And the Knights still not giving this top line of the Saints any room to breathe. Sexton back in front, finding that one with Zarbo. Shot that one and held by Winninger.
Nice play by Ben Sexton to come out of his own zone with speed. Made a nice outside move. Threw that one to the front. Looked like he was trying to get Jared Burton on the one-timer. His stick was tied up. But a heads-up play there by Joe Zarbo to fall back a little, find that one, and then wheel it towards the net, trying to find Jared Burton or Ben Sexton crashing hard. Matt Winninger able to blocker that one down and get the glove on it, cover it up before a Clarkson player could again find that one in front of the net.
Holding on to this one now is Doherty. He'll lift that one into the ninth zone. After here is Howden. Drive from Hughes, blocked by Howden as well, as that one lifted up by Ward. Ward will run into Howden, and that one, I believe, got a piece of the glass. Actually, it's going to be played by a high stick here, staying in the ninth zone. Howden was the one who got a piece of it.
James Howden trying to knock that one down. Got it a little too high for the referee's liking. Then touched it up. Referee blowing the whistle, allowing both teams to face off here in the Clarkson defensive zone.
swatting at that one was Howden, able to get that off the glass around here for Denalo. Denalo gets that one past Riley. Down the length of the ice after it now is McPherson. McPherson now throwing on the brakes in the corner, holding here back for Denalo. Denalo with a wrister, and that one stopped in traffic.
Nice play by Jeff Denalo to again. Clarkson falling back on the rush a little bit. Don't want to get all your guys right towards the front. Want to have someone falling back as the late man in. That time Jeff Denalo did it to perfection. Was able to get off a really good shot. It looked like it hit a St. Lawrence shin pad before it could get to Wenninger in front.
Holding on to this one now is LeBrec. Ahead gets that one to Moore. Moore had it taken away there by Bayreuther, who will take a little bit of a body check there from Josephs. Esri now shouldered off the puck. Shot from Bayreuther, deflected over the net there by Lewis. Got a piece of the netting there as it rode around the top of the high glass. Faceoff coming in the ninth zone. But really, Sam LeBrec back on the blue line this season, not really putting up the numbers we saw from him his freshman year. Of course, in his career so far, 79 games with 35 points, and this season alone with 4 points as well. So pretty good numbers for LeBrec, not what we saw out of him in his freshman year. Josephs with another shot, and that one stopped by Wenninger. Of course, with the successful freshman year that LeBrec had, it's a little hard to replicate that year in and year out.
Well, Sam LeBrec came in a little unknown commodity, but he's turned into a real good player for Clarkson University. Really shows up on the power play, likes to use that patented slap shot from the point. He's really turned himself from what, when he was here his freshman year, was more of a one-dimensional offensive player, has turned himself into a pretty good two-way defenseman. Not the biggest guy, but certainly knows how to use the size he has and the strength that he packs in that slightly smaller frame, uses it very well defending.
Puck drop here, and Dahl will be tossed out of the faceoff dot. McGovern will come in to try to take this one away from Sexton. Able to do so with ease as this one comes back to the blue line. Holding there, Hudson has it stripped away by DeHaas, and Sexton will swing it around there for Joe Zarbo. Did well to tie up his man Dahl along the boards, and Dahl will find this here. Back across for Baker. Baker keeping that one in. After it here is Hudson. Hudson will take the hit from DeHaas back in front. Dahl in all alone. Poked at there. Couldn't get the shot off. Lewis was out to challenge nicely. As that one tipped, goes off the high glass. McGovern will take it here for SLU. Back to Baker, and Baker will hold here. Swinging back around. Chasing it down now is Sexton. Sexton through the lugs. Picked up by McGovern. Shaking off one man in the corner. Back around for Dahl. The third line out now for the Saints, and Dahl will take a crushing blow there from Sexton. Drive, stopped in front. That one slides through the crease on the second-hand chance by the Saints. McGovern holding this one, swinging it back for Baker. Baker met there by Burton. Boak now poking at this one as well, trying to work it free, and Matt Carey will join the fray. Holding on to this one is Sweetman. He'll lift it into the Knights' zone and head to the bench for a change of his own. Matt Carey trying to work free from DeHaas. Picked up by Joe Zarbo, and that one slung down the length of the ice. Icing going to be called as racing back for that one was McMullen.
Joe Zarbo, usually known for his offense, but on that last shift, and he's actually going to stay out there now because of that icing, made a really nice play in front of the net, was able to get back and tie up the stick of Alex Dahl, the freshman, looking for his second of the year. He was all alone in on Lewis. He unfortunately couldn't handle that puck for just a second. Had to give it a second to lay down, and then when he tried to shoot, Joe Zarbo able to come back and get a stick on him, not allow him to get that shot off.
After this one is Matt Carey, shouldered off the puck there by Burton, trying to find it. Here is Matt Zarbo playing it off the glass, stopped there by McMullen. Shot stopped by Lewis, kicked out to the point there, and Austin will step into one, cleared out of the zone though. Glove back down by DeHaas, holding now, shaking this one ahead, gets the rain line. He'll dump that one in so the Knights can get the fire wagon chain. Fresh legs over the boards after this one is Frederick, who throws a big blow in the corner there on Riley. Trying to work this one free is Bissett, picked up now by Greg Carey. Has that one poked away. And then the Knights really shutting down the Carey brothers here so far. Stopped there by Matt Zarbo. He'll dump it back in there for Bissett. Still trying to get it free from McMullen. This one over the head of Tanzius. He'll chase this one down. Icing waved off. Ahead there. Frederick will backhand it into the zone. After it now is Bayreuther. Bayreuther leaving it there for McMullen. Up the boards now. Gets this one ahead for Hughes. And Hughes trying to work around Geiger. Gargle will slow him down on the boards. Lebrecht swinging it back around. Stopped there by Ward. Met by McPherson. And Lebrecht now chases this one ahead. For Frederick, walking ahead for McPherson. He's got McGinnity with him as well. And Geiger now joining the rush across for Geiger. Geiger holding wrist shot, saved by Winninger. Loose puck. McGinnity couldn't pull that one back around. Holding there is Ward. Has it poked away by McGinnity momentarily. And now picked up and started the other way there. Tossed ahead by Rally. Poked at there by Lebrecht, doing a good job at the blue line. As this one comes back to Lebrecht on the near side from Geiger. Up ahead, gets that one. Getting a piece of it was McPherson, as Winninger will cover that one.
Pat McGinnity with another chance. That time Al McPherson streaking up the right-hand wing. McGinnity goes hard to the net. McPherson finds Geiger jumping up from the defense. A good wrist shot that Winninger was only able to stop. Couldn't grab it. Dropped down in front. McGinnity tried to wheel that one towards the net. Looked like it just rolled off the heel of his stick, as he couldn't really get off a very good shot. Move that one towards Matt Winninger and force him to try to make another save.
Holding on to this one now and carrying ahead is Baker. Baker now leading the charge through the neutral zone, pestered by Josephs. Boak now after Baker, as Baker will drop that one back off for Esri. Met there by Josephs as Josephs goes down, only glancing off Esri there. Paulson trying to work free from Hagen. He'll stand up Esri in the corner, and Esri going down. Josephs couldn't get all of that one. Played back in by Wick, and after it now is Boak. Boak will hold on to this one here. Played ahead for DeHaas. DeHaas now out of his own zone. Moving that one around. Stopped though and picked up by Dahl. Dahl walking in on Boak. McMullen with it now. Shot that one over the crossbar and off the high glass as well. Sliding out of the ninth zone. Picked up now by Riley. Riley working this one. Backhands it into the zone. After it here is Boak. Boak seeing McGovern coming. Slowed down on that one. And DeHaas now joining the fray as well with Dahl. Coming in to scoop up the puck is Josephs, ahead for Moore. Moore losing it there in the skates. Hudson joining as well. Moore still spotting it. That one gets it out of the blue line. Working past Riley. Taken down by Riley in the process. And Riley going to get called on the interference. So ahead of the box there is Riley Austin.
Riley had the right idea. Or Riley Austin, excuse me, had the right idea, just the wrong execution. If he had laid that hip check a little earlier, it would have been a clean hit, and you see him a little frustrated. He goes off to the penalty box just a little late, getting over there to cut off TJ Moore, who used some good speed to try to get around him. So now Clarkson with another power play opportunity, had one to start this period, have one now with 13:35 left in the second.
This one back for Lebrecht. Lebrecht now walking the blue line with this one around for DeHaas. DeHaas holds, sends it back around for Donalo. Donalo's pass stopped there and lifted down the length of the ice. This one wide of Lewis. Lewis out to hold onto this one. Doherty putting on the pressure as this one wrapped back around for Lebrecht. Lewis will make his way back to his net. Donalo across, turnover there. Doherty finds himself with it in the Knights zone. Swarmed though by four Knights, and poking at this one is McGinnity and Lebrecht. Squirting out and picking it up here is Tansy. Donalo getting the feet going, joining the rush. Tansy will play that one in and around the boards as this one wraps down. McPherson trying to get there in time. Baker will send it the other way. As that one's cleared down the length of the ice there by Sweetman. So some freshmen really coming out big so far. Mainly the likes of Eric Sweetman and Gavin Bayreuther. Two freshmen back on defense that have been playing pretty solid minutes so far for the Saints.
They've both been good, and Bayreuther's credited with that second goal for the Saints off a nice slap shot. He was able to find some room to get that one past Greg Lewis. They've both been good not only in the offensive zone but in the defensive zone as well. It's always hard when you're a freshman to come and try to play big-time college hockey, but they've both stepped up here and have played well.
Rising shot from Geiger hit the high glass. Shot from Tansy, and that one in the glove of Winninger. He'll hold on to that one. With 41 seconds left on that interference call to Riley Austin.
Clarkson going to keep that line out there. Ben Sexton, TJ Moore, Joe Zarbo, Kevin Tansy, and Paul Geiger back at the points is the line, of course, that capitalized on Clarkson's first power play opportunity. Casey Jones trying to find if lightning will strike twice as it did for St. Lawrence.
Holding this one is Lewis, leaving it there. Doherty putting on the pressure. Tansy now joining to get this one free, and Sexton will pick it back up. Gets a glance at the Jumbotron here. Plays it in there. Moore will chase it down with Sexton as well. Two going in on the forecheck. Moore swinging this one back. Looking for the man at the point. Has it taken away, though, and Baker ahead finds Doherty. Doherty cross now for Baker. Baker with a shot towards net. Stop there. Hughes got a piece of it. Sexton will take Hughes into the corner and picked up by LeBrec. Bring us to the end of the nice power play. Getting that one ahead out of the reach of Moore. Icing going to be called as Sweetman got there in time for the Saints.
That pass, TJ Moore was able to get a piece of it, but he wasn't past the red line when he got it. Casey Jones sending his team some instructions as both squads back to 5-on-5. Clarkson right now, after only giving up 4 shots in that first period, right now, big board inside Cheel says only 6 for St. Lawrence. Clarkson with 14, so almost equaling their output from that entire first period here so far, not even 10 minutes into the second.
DeHaas pulling in this one, trying to work it free. Back to Doherty, shot. That one stopped getting a piece of it was Greg Carey. Holding on to this one now is Sexton, playing ahead, gets it to Joe Zarbo, trying to work free here around Baker. Joe Zarbo with a rising shot, that one off the glass, drops down. Greg Carey with a nice finesse move between the legs. Ahead gets it one to Matt Zarbo from Howden, and Zarbo will throw it into the far side corner. After it here is Bissett, drops it off for Frederick, shot saved by Wenninger. After this one now here is Martin, he'll stop that one, picked up here by Matt Carey. Matt Carey working this one ahead, delays to the corner. Boak will take him hard in the boards. Carey looked to have his head snap back pretty violently on that one, and Zarbo playing this one ahead for Bissett. Bissett still trying to work free from McMullen as he goes down. Frederick tied up with his man down low, and Austin now joining the fray. So Austin and McMullen, the two defenders back there. Puck not moving, referee going to blow the whistle. Pretty quickly on that one from the referee. Usually see him give him a couple warnings, maybe one or two given that time before the referee decided to move that one away from the boards. Drop going to be just here to the right of Matt Wenninger.
I think the referee decided to blow that one with all the big bodies that were down there trying to just not let that puck get away. Didn't look like too much was going on. Referee smartly blowing that one for a lot of time was wasted. What would have probably end up being a helpless cause.
McGovern trying to work this one free, had it swatted away there by Geiger. And offside going to be the call on St. Lawrence.
This line for Clarkson really has been very good. Jeff Denalo, we talked about him, had 4 points in that last weekend's game against Queens. First, that was exhibition, but people not really knowing much about Queens, they were undefeated coming into that game and not lost all year up in Canada. And then that game, Clarkson was able to hand them their first loss of the season, even in an exhibition match.
Tansy with a shot that got deflected going wide. Denalo will step into his man, take a big hit there from Sweetman, who saw Denalo look to have him lined up. After this one now is Geiger racing in on Hudson as well, and he'll take Hudson into the boards. Tansy will poke at it, trying to get it free from the skates of Hudson, able to do so pretty well there. Nice stick work by Tansy. McPherson tracking that one, tried to find Denalo. Stopped in the neutral zone by McGinnity. McGinnity holds, fires that one in on Wenninger. He'll be forced to play that one aside with the blocker, and out now it comes Fawson with Frederick and Josephs. A little bit different look on this line for Casey Jones. Cross ice as this one slides towards Wenninger. Icing will be waved off as this one comes to the near side here for Baker. Baker wrapping it around the boards to the far side, gets it there for Ward, and Ward will dump it in, taking Boak out in the process. DeHaas trying to get this one free from Doherty. Ahead for Frederick. Frederick holding to the near side for Fawson. Swatting that one, unable to get that one ahead and out of the zone as this one's held by DeHaas, playing it back around for Boak. Boak holding, calling for it there was Frederick. Got a piece, and that one deflected up and into the stands on the far side. So that one going to be out of play, deflected right at the red line. Faceoff going to be, I believe, at neutral ice is what it looks like from how the players are lining up.
That one got deflected by Will Frederick out of play. The referee is going to blow it there. That one went into the stands. Bring the faceoff back out to center ice. Ben Sexton out to take it. First line coming back out for the Knights. They've had their problems in the offensive zone when they've been matched up against the carry line, but when they've been in the offensive zone, this line has been very productive and has really given St. Lawrence some problems.
After this one now is Burton carrying ahead. Drags this one, making the move towards the front of the net is Jared Burton. This one picked up now by LeBrec. Around four, Sexton got a piece of it. Trying to work free there from Rally. As this one comes back for LeBrec. Wrist shot from LeBrec, and that one off some shin pads and into the netting.
Another good shift by this line, bringing that one into the offensive zone. A good play by Jared Burton to use his speed and size to get around the St. Lawrence defender and then cut to the middle. A really nice job by him shielding off the St. Lawrence defender, keeping that puck one hand on his stick, was able to get it to the front. No Clarkson players could find it there laying in the crease. Wenninger was trying to deal with the speed from Jared Burton.
Tied up there along the boards. This one picked up by Austin. Austin ahead gets that one to Greg Carey, swatting at it, trying to get past Geiger. It looks like the line, or defensive pairing rather, of Tansy and Geiger has been responsible for this top line of Carey, and Martin. Seems like with that last change, Casey Jones has used it pretty wisely to match up this sophomore tandem with the potent first line of the Saints.
Well, both these sophomores are big and can skate. Knows they're very good and responsible in their own zone. So sending them out there to try to take on what has been a pretty dynamic duo, the leading freshman scorer and the leading scorer overall in the country. It's hard to match up against them, but so far so good for this Clarkson Golden Knights.
This one picked up here by Matt Carey, gloved down by DeHaas. DeHaas, of course, out there with Boak now after Tansy had lost his stick. Ahead gets that one off the skate of Matt Zarbo into the night zone. Great carry ahead for Doherty. Doherty will hold here, working with Gunnar Hughes as well, looking for Hughes, tied up nicely though by Boak, and Hughes going down in the corner. Boak will pick it up here, trying to turn this one around. Tied up with Doherty and Ward, and Ward getting his head up, looking in front, deflected there, kept in the zone nicely there by Sweetman. Back in, drop down low for Doherty, wrapping around for Gunnar Hughes, in front for Ward, held by Lewis. Great reactionary save there by the Clarkson netminder.
Alex Boak did a good job tying up his man in front, but then didn't head to try to then atone for his sin as he gave up that puck right to St. Lawrence down low in their offensive zone. Boak got pressured by two guys and just could not throw that one up the boards before he got stripped of it. Got to be careful, the St. Lawrence team. We talked about how dangerous they are on offense. They can score from anywhere. If you give them opportunities, they will capitalize.
Big rebound and teeing off that one was Sweetman. That one goes wide. Sent back in front. Loose puck scooped up by McPherson. Three, two on one developing. Out comes McPherson with McGinnity. McPherson now racing in. Looks, shot, rebound in front. Denala with another chance, and Wenninger holds on. Excellent job there to avoid that flurry of activity from the Golden Knights.
Al McPherson coming in two on one with Pat McGinnity. Nice job by McPherson to avoid getting tripped up there in his own zone and then working out with that two on one chance. Look to try to get that over to McGinnity. The left-handed shot would have been hard for McGinnity to get off a shot by the time McPherson could have gotten it over to him, so he smartly tried to shoot it. Didn't get off a very good shot, though. Wenninger was able to make the save and then cover up for the rebound.
Tansy playing that one off the boards. Joseph's trying to work this one in out there with Moore and Fawson. Picked up here, though, and held by Rally. He's trying to work it free as this one comes out to McGovern. Unable to get a piece of that one, and McGovern will get it right back past Tansy now. Two on one for St. Lawrence going down, and glove save by Lewis. Excellent play there from the Clarkson netminder, denying Hudson of what would have been his third of the year.
And a quick whistle from the referee as he thought Greg Lewis had it in the glove. Greg Lewis did momentarily, but a little help there from the referee before St. Lawrence could find that one. So they still had an opportunity coming, but a nice save by Greg Lewis. A good job by Kevin Tansy to hustle back. Right now he's getting to talk with Casey Jones just about what he did wrong there and what he's got to try to do better next time he's out.
Howden trying to force that turnover Hagen will hold on to this one, racing back behind the Clarkson net. Shot from Hagen, stopped by Lewis, and he'll get this one back down low. I believe Howden's going to be going to the box there as the referee's arm goes up in the air. Stopped and touched there by Sexton. And tripping going to be the call, that one on James Howden.
Howden taking down his man down low. So far, so good for the Saints on the power play, 2 for 2. They have been absolutely deadly. They've also increased their shot total now up to 10. Much better job by them. Once we hit that 10-minute mark, St. Lawrence has sort of evened this game back up a little bit. Clarkson still has had the better of the chances other than that one really good chance that Greg Lewis had to make a spectacular save on. But now St. Lawrence gets to do what they do best, and that's go on the power play 2 for 2 here tonight. Clarkson in desperate need of a penalty kill to keep this game tied up at 2.
Holding there is Wick, now to Baker, now to Bayreuther into the near side for Greg Carey. Greg now back to Bayreuther, around now to Baker. Baker holding, poked at by Sexton. Geiger now coming over to put on some pressure. Wick will find this one. Stopped there by Matt Carey, puck up in the air, glove down by Greg. Sending this one back to Bayreuther, shot wide of the net. Loose puck still, Lewis making one save, another save, and Lewis fantastic there as this one comes back now for Greg Carey. Cross now for Bayreuther, back now to Baker. Baker holding now back to Bayreuther to the near side for Greg Carey. Shot there, and that one wide of everything. Missed by a couple inches on that one was the senior Greg Carey, who can really fire a pretty fast wrister.
Greg Carey, don't normally see him take too many slap shots that time. Trying to get the wrist shot, trying to beat Greg Lewis on the glove side after Lewis made an outstanding save with the blocker. I believe it was Baker dropped in from the point. Tried to get a backdoor shot off on Lewis. He made a very good save.
Holding on to this one here is Baker. Got some options on the near side, making the move around McPherson. Bayreuther with a shot. That one deflected up and into the netting. That'll stay in the ninth zone. And now Wick and Boak exchanging some words. Look to be pretty tied up there. Nobody really wants to budge here.
Wick's been working in front of that net. That's where he likes to be parked. Was there on that first Bayreuther goal that he blasted in from the point. Having some words though with Alex Boak, who also likes to work a little bit in front of that net. Doing a good job keeping Wick away out of front of his goaltender, letting Greg Lewis see the play develop. Lewis has really great vision, and we saw it on display on that great save he made on a Baker on the back door. Had to really move over quick, got the blocker out, deflected it up and into the glass.
And of course, Matt, you and I both know Alex Boak, one of the more gentle guys on the ice there for Clarkson. Really likes to have some nice conversations with people after the play. Nonetheless, though, St. Lawrence trying to capitalize now with the second power play unit. Haven't seen much of them. The first power play unit really was getting the job done here. Shut down so far with just 25 seconds left on the power play. They'll send out a line of Ward, Doherty, and Hughes. So Doherty back in front for Ward. That one going just wide. Doherty will kick this one back around for Gunnar Hughes. He'll wrap around the boards here for the freshman Sweetman. Back to Hughes now, and Hughes will turn. Drop this one back off for Ward. Ward holding now, going back to Hughes. Getting the head up, working a cycle here back for Ward. Ward with a shot, that one wide. After it now is Burton, and the Knights killing off that penalty back to even strength. Boak trying to work this one free. Doherty met by Burton there, pinned against the boards. Back for Hughes. Hughes holding here. Hughes making the move in front. That puck will skitter to the far side. Doherty will find it here. Sexton trying to work that one free. Back from McMullen. Drive held by Lewis as he'll hang on to that one. Excellent job by Greg Lewis to get a much-needed change. And the Knights kill off their first penalty successfully here against a very good power play of the Saints.
And a rousing ovation for the Knights as they get some love from the crowd here for their first successful penalty kill of the game. St. Lawrence now 2 for 3, still pretty good at 66.6 repeating percent. But when Clarkson really needed it there, a good kill to keep this game tied up at 2 in this second period.
That one will stay in the rink. Bissette trying to work it free along with Matt Zarbo. Howden will swat out now, and Hudson gets his chance with it. He's got a man in front going hard on the net with Dahl. Good save by Lewis. Hudson, though, with a pretty veteran move there, shooting to the far side, hoping for that kick out in front, which happened. Dahl just couldn't get the stick on it. Frederick still trying to work free here from McGovern. Joining the rush as well there was Matt Zarbo. The Haas tied up with his man. Picking it up here is Frederick. Dropping it off, and out comes Bissette. Bissette in a foot race there with Rally, and Rally will take Bissette hard into the boards. Winninger will slow it down there for St. Lawrence. Back across, Lebrecht getting a piece of that one at the blue line, playing it back in. Offside is delayed. Tagging up there was Bissett as this one stopped there by McPherson. McPherson now carries this one in. Rest of the line out with him as well. Saved by Winninger off the blocker, and Danala will wrap it back around there. McPherson taking his man to the boards, getting some help from McGinnity. Tied up there with Bayreuther, and now picked up here by Rowley, lifting it ahead for Hudson. Played back in by Lebrecht, and after it here now is McPherson. Hudson will find it there, stripped away in the neutral zone by McGinnity. Cross ice now for McPherson, trying to get the feet going.
Ellen McPherson arguing he had stopped that one before it got into the zone. Ellen McPherson, not the most vocal of guys out there, but certainly felt like he had done a good job. That puck bounced in his skates, and he was offsides, but it didn't look like he had brought the puck totally into the zone. You can still control it from there as long as the puck stays out. The referee seeing a little bit differently. We'll have to trust his judgment. As I said earlier, those are the guys that get paid to make those decisions.
This one played back around. Geiger's still trying to work it free. Gets that one away from Esri there, and now after it, finding it is Burton. Burton will lift that one in, trying to work it free there. Stepping into his man along the boards, and Esri will work it free ahead for Wick. Wick now trying to get around Geiger. Geiger staying with him rather nicely, and Tansy will go after this one down low. Big hit from Wick. Tansy goes down and taking his man down in front. Still a loose puck. Tansy back to his feet now, battling with Wick, and Sexton getting his man out of the way. Still nothing coming on this play, and a big hit there. Esri will pay the price for St. Lawrence. So Tansy back up, taking some exception to the hit he received from Wick, really giving him a few pleasantries there. It's this one held by Baker. As this one comes to the near side, Esri will lift it back in, and after it here is Tansy. Big hit from Greg Carey on Tansy. And this one comes back ahead. Burton now ahead to Joe Zarbo. Zarbo will walk this one in, out with Matt Zarbo as well. Both sets of brothers out on the ice right now. Walking ahead is Martin. He's got Matt and Greg Carey. Back ahead for McMullen. McMullen making the move around one. Back in front, they score. That one's Matt Carey waiting on the doorstep. Able to find that one. And SLU will get that one goal lead back with 38 seconds remaining in the second.
You can see that play developing all the way up from center ice. A nice job by St. Lawrence to come into the zone with speed. McMullen jumps up into the play, makes a move around a man, finds Matt Carey sitting on the doorstep. That's going to be his 10th, and I'm not sure he had one much easier than that all year. Bad job by Clarkson, not finding their men in front of the net. And just like that, again, St. Lawrence capitalizes late in the period with 38.6 seconds left in the second to take the 3-2 lead.
And Kevin Tansy, a guy who doesn't really look flustered that often on defense, looked pretty out of sync after taking that big hit from Wick down low. Maybe could have argued a boarding was in order there. This one, McPherson had a chance there. He got tied up. Penalty going to be coming up as he was hooked there clearly, or else that one would have been past Winninger in the Knights. Just like that, almost 7 seconds later, put one in the back of the net. Penalty, though, Baker will take smartly for his team. We'll just hope for St. Lawrence's sake that they can keep the Knights off the board on this power play.
And that's a great way to respond for the Knights. Casey Jones gathers up his team, tells them, listen, I know it's bad to get scored on late, but we got to come out in this last 30 seconds and we got to put some pressure on. McPherson actually won the faceoff at center ice forward to himself. Found Jeff Danalo streaking in, who tried to find him in front. Just couldn't get there as McPherson was taken down and hooked on the play.
Holding now is Lebrecht. He'll work this one up the ice ahead. Got a piece of it was McGinnity and started back the other way by Sweetman. Lewis will stop it now. Picked up again now by Lebrecht, trying to get this one and things going for the Knights. Ahead is McPherson. McPherson stepping into that one, sending it wide of the SLU net. That one going to be bringing us to the end there. McGinnity taken down after the play, and now Danalo not happy with Gunnar Hughes. Linesman going to step in, prevent things from getting too ugly. And the Saints have a one-goal lead after two periods of play, 3-2. We'll get you back for the start of the third. Stay tuned on WCKN.
Whatever it is, the answer is no.
Don't even think about it. acting like a baby.
Why can't you do anything right?
What were you thinking?
You're driving me crazy. How come you're never home?
You never want to talk to me. Why don't you ever listen?
Could it be they really are listening? What you say does make a difference in your child's life. If you're searching for the right words, Boys Town can help. Just call 1-800-448-3000 or on the web at parenting.org. Boys Town National Hotline. In New York, call 1-800-448-3000.
Separate.
So the Saints come back in that second period of play, put one more on the board, have that one goal lead, 3-2 over the Golden Knights so far. It came late in that period. Goal from Matt Carey on a pretty easy shot from him, really. Wide open net, excellent setup from Ross McMullen. And the Saints take that one goal lead. Let's take a look at the stats, though, from that second period of play. Or we can just talk about it, Matt. So in that second period of play, really, as you can see here, Clarkson getting some shots on the board as they lead in that category. 12 saves for Greg Lewis of Clarkson and 17 for Matt Wenninger. And there you go, Matt. The Knights coming back. We saw they have that 55.3% win rate in the faceoff dot, really coming back. 28 wins for them. We saw late there in that third period in a response to that goal, McPherson winning one forward to himself and had a pretty darn good chance at maybe tying this game back up, but Baker took a penalty there to deny him of that opportunity with Pat McGinnity up front, and that's why the Knights are on the power play here. But really, a good job with some nice puck movement for the Saints to get that third goal.
That third goal is really all started out at center ice. A good break in by the Saints. Really had Clarkson moving around. They didn't know where they were going. Just looked like they were a little confused about who was taking who. And then this pass back here to McMillan feeds, really puts it right on the stick of Matt Carey. That's the easiest one. He's going to score all year. A bad job by the Knights finding their guys in the zone. No one there to help out their goaltender, Greg Lewis. Not much he can do about that. He's trying to face up McMillan. Makes a really nice pass to find Carey, who puts it into the back of the net. His first as part of this rivalry. Look for him to maybe try to have many more. He looks like he's going to be a special player for the Saints.
Of course, Matt and Carey getting on the board. The Knights, though, have given little to no space at all to his counterpart in crime and older brother, Greg Carey. Not much going for him tonight. It seems like every time he has the puck, it's either Ben Sexton, Jared Burton, or Joe Zarbo throwing a nice big body check his way, and he has not had much room to work at all.
Well, the one thing you got to know is Greg Carey, a scorer like him, he's going to be frustrated early on, later on in this game. He hasn't had the puck as much as he'd like. He wants to have that puck. He wants to be the guy that scores those game-winning goals. He wants to be the guy in control. He hasn't had it. That's been a good job for Clarkson. Likewise, in puck possession, they've got to get it to their forwards a little bit more. The defense have been playing around with the puck a little bit too much in their own defensive zone. Seen a couple of giveaways that have almost cost the Knights. The one actually did a giveaway up at center ice that St. Lawrence is able to take back into the zone. Ends up with Matt Carey's goal. So Clarkson needs to work on getting that puck up and then getting it to their forwards, allowing them to have the puck. They're the ones that are going to make plays. They're the ones that are going to score the goals. They're the ones that are going to get Clarkson back into this game.
So we'll see which team can handle that puck in the third period. We'll see if the Knights come back to equalize or if the Saints start to pull away. Nonetheless, we'll figure out who comes away the victor in this battle of the North Country. Stay tuned for the third period here on WCKN. Welcome back here to Cheel Arena. Things have kind of quieted down a little bit here, Matt. Really, St. Lawrence taking the air up out of the building. A few fans from St. Lawrence making their way over here. A little bit of a sea of red down to our right. And a few other SLU fans scattered throughout. But nothing in comparison to that mass of gold in the far right-hand side of the arena, Matt. The student section participating in the fourth annual Gold Out. And, of course, all of the students sporting free T-shirts with Clarkson's record overall against St. Lawrence. One that you could say is pretty definitive. 118, 65, and 10 in favor of the Golden Knights.
And under Casey Jones, we talked about it, 7-1-1. He's hoping his team could come out here on the power play and try to get this game back to even, so it's looking, it looked more like he could make it to 8-1-1 in his career as the Clarkson University head coach against St. Lawrence.
Chasing this one down is McPherson as we're underway in the third. Denalo getting a piece of it, sending it around for McPherson. This one scutters out to Doherty. Unable to get a piece of that one was Rally. McPherson now trying to force another turnover. Doherty will find this one lifted out of the zone down the length of the ice. DeHaas will get to it with 1:05 left on the power play. Off the boards, Denalo corrals it with the skate. Back to DeHaas. DeHaas walking this one ahead. Drops it off there for McGinnity. McGinnity in, throws on the brakes, swings it back around, trying to get this one to McPherson. Sweetman shoved off the puck there by Denalo. Denalo playing it back now to Lebrecq. Lebrecq now back to McPherson. McPherson walking in, shot, sort of saved by Wenninger. Holding here is Lebrecq. Lebrecq with another shot through traffic, tied up. Loose puck still, this one sliding. When comes out of the zone, Lebrecq just couldn't get there in time. Across for DeHaas, that one played back in. DeHaas held up as the linesman's arm went in the air for the offside call, of course, then immediately went waving it off as soon as DeHaas went back to the bench, looked a little bit frustrated that the linesman couldn't make up his mind. Geiger will drop that one back off there for Zarbo, back to Sexton. Sexton fanning on it, still trying to work it free as Zarbo plays it back in across. McGovern playing that one out of the zone and chasing it down. Here is Geiger. The Knights, though, Matt, as we talked about amongst the two of us during that intermission, really need to come out fast here. Need to get a good start, put a goal on the board to equalize. Better to get that one on the board and then try to get a game winner later than focus on having to get two in a row late.
It's always better to try to score early in the period. They were gifted a nice chance there again by St. Lawrence taking that penalty. We're unable to capitalize once again. St. Lawrence has been very good on the penalty kill after giving up that first Clarkson goal. Clarkson has really been having problems getting into the zone, not only on the power play, but on 5-on-5.
Great carry tied up there with Howden down low, Boak joining in as well. And Carey sending this one back out to the point there for Rally to the near side now for Bayreuther. Now back around for Martin. Martin will find it here. Still trying to work it free. After it here is Martin. Martin holding, dropping back off for Bayreuther. Bayreuther now swings it back around off the outside of the net. Matt Carey was waiting for it behind the net. Drop back around. After it here is McGovern. McGovern holding, swinging it back around. Still trying to find Martin. Martin still putting the pressure on the Knights in the offensive zone is swatting that one is Bissett, as well as Matt Zarbo playing that one back to Howden, swinging it back across here for Boak, and Boak now will hold, swinging it out and down the length of the ice. After here is Frederick, gets the icing waved off, has Bissett in front. Frederick saw that hit coming, just chose to take it into the boards. Frederick still tries to work this one free, coming out with it is Rally, takes a big hit there from Josephs as this one walked back ahead now by McGovern. McGovern has Hudson in the zone as well. Shoved off the puck there by Lebrecq. Back around for Hudson. Hudson met by DeHaas. And Hudson now with a backhander that goes through the crease. Shot there from Sweetman and held on to by Lewis.
That puck going to come up to the right of the Clarkson netminder to the near side of the ice. Good job by Greg Lewis fighting off that shot from Sweetman as that one was rising, coming up at him quick. Had to throw the shoulder up there, was able to grab that one, not allow a rebound chance. Not a good angle for the shot, but a shot that certainly looked like it had Greg Lewis a little bit worried, but a good job by him to grab that one and cover it up.
Picked up now by Geiger, playing that one ahead, turnover, and that one played right back in by Sweetman. After it there was Geiger, plays it around for Fawson. Boston is still trying to work it free, and Geiger taken down in the corner there by Ezri. Gets back to his feet, still tied up in the skates of the referee. Seems like he wants to be one of the SLU players that for there for a little while, really preventing Clarkson from that nice breakout. With a wraparound chance, that one slid back in front. Fawson will find himself with it. Wick's pass couldn't find anyone in front. Fawson lost an edge in the process as well. Tansy playing that one in and chasing after it here is Josephs to the near side here for Wick. Up the ice trying to find Ward, and Howden will race back after it. Getting there in time, dropping it off for Tansy. Tansy holding, going back across ice there for Howden. Howden leading the charge off the skates of Denalo. McGinnity couldn't get a stick on it. And now Doherty carries this one ahead for SLU. Shot towards the net, deflected going wide. Ward will find it here. Picked up there by McPherson ahead for McGinnity. McGinnity couldn't find that one, and McPherson now racing after it, taking a hard collision there along the boards. Ward will toss this one in and around. Slowing it down was Lewis. Backhanding it to the near side for Lebrecht. Now Denalo will find it. And the Knights really having a hard time connecting on those breakout passes. A lot of passes seem to be going just wide of sticks, and Clarkson unable to really bring that puck with him. Seems like it's been all St. Lawrence in terms of passing and puck possession so far, Matt.
As that one goes up into the netting, deflected up, going to come back again to the right of Greg Lewis. But back to what you were saying there, Brandon, I absolutely agree. Clarkson has not had that puck possession. Seems like when that puck's getting to him, whether by bad luck, that puck is just bouncing around, not really been able to control it very well. They don't seem to be able to be making those really good passes out of the zone. Right now it's really ending in a lot of zone control, a lot of puck possession for St. Lawrence. That's especially not good for Clarkson, considering they're still down by one. Haven't really generated much offense to speak of here in this third period so far.
Bissett sending that one back around, finding Matt Zarbo, dropping it back off for Frederick, and Frederick shoved off the puck there by Matt Carey, picked up by Rally. Rally trying to get it out. Geiger will pinch down on his man. Matt Zarbo playing it in and around, trying to get it past Geiger, and Geiger has it tied up in the skates. Back now for Frederick. Frederick working on his man, Bayreuther, still trying to get free. Tied up there, Matt Carey will come in for some assistance. Stopped at the blue line by Geiger. Pressure now from Greg Carrier across for Tansy. Tansy off the boards gently ahead for Bissett.
I think that one went off a glove of one of the Clarkson players, resting his hands up there on the bench. That's why they're going to blow that one down. Going to bring the face off outside of the Clarkson zone to the far side of the ice. The two number 14s getting set to face off. Ben Sexton, the captain, out for the Knights to take the draw.
This one held here by Sweetman. He'll race this one into the zone. Shot deflected up and into the netting. And really, this first line for the Knights has seen most of their time so far out against that carry line with Chris Martin on the right wing. Really haven't seen a lot of them in terms of offensive production, with the exception of the power play out there. Are Burton and Sexton on that power play, but really not a whole lot coming out of Jaron Burton, one of those guys who really stepped up big last year, produced a lot of offense, and was doing a lot of that earlier this season. Haven't seen much out of him so far in this game. A guy who's usually a pretty big factor in most of the games we've seen here at home.
Jaron Burton, a pretty timely goal scorer, as we can remember from a couple of games last year. Really knows when to step up, just sort of has a knack for stepping up. A little bit of clutch in these big games right now. They could use some clutch, whether it's from Jaron Burton or for anyone else for that matter. Clarkson in desperate need some offensive firepower.
Back for Burton, he scores! And just like we called it, Matt, Jaron Burton needed to be Mr. Clutch, and he does just that. Excellent behind the back pass from Joe Zarbo.
And when you talk about clutch and coming through at the right time, Jaron Burton certainly does it. Jaron Burton comes in on a beautiful feed. A nice job by Joe Zarbo to feed that over to Jaron Burton and allow him to snipe that one past Matt Leininger. A little bit of clutch from the senior, and he's got his fourth of the year. And boy, do we know how to pick him sometimes, talking about guys in game, and they reward you like that.
And Josephs dumps Wick, going hard into the end boards. There was Hagen. I believe this one's going to come out of the zone here. and Essery going to argue it. Not sure what the call is here. Faceoff, though, will be outside of the Clarkson zone. And, Matt, I don't know what it is. Today you're on a roll. We talk about Jared Burton. He scores earlier. We talk about going to the net. UND does just that and gets one past Erica Howe. So, really, if you want to talk up some more game about Clarkson, what they need to do and put one in the net, I'm sure most of the Cheel faithful and a lot of the students over there in the Gold Church would not mind at all.
Well, I mean, for Clarkson, now that they've got this tied up, they have to play some defense. You know, St. Lawrence is going to come out. They're going to respond with their first line. You got to come out, play some defense, try to weather this early storm. There's always a period about 2 to 3 minutes after there's a goal scored for your team that the other team really just tries to push against you really hard, tries to get that one back or at least get some of that momentum that you get that they give up on that goal. St. Lawrence going to try that here. For Clarkson, the next couple of shifts have to be good. You have to be crisp with your passes and make sure you get it out of the zone.
This one held by Rally. He'll send it back around. Boat got a piece of it. After it, here's Hughes. He'll be shoved off the puck by DeHaas. And tying up down low is Ward. McPherson gets that one ahead for Donalo. Out for McGinnity off of his skate. And that will be played right back in by Rally. DeHaas shooting that one around the boards. Stopped by Hughes. He'll take a shoulder check there from Boak. DeHaas trying to work this one back down. Donalo holding here across for McPherson. McPherson out with McGinnity. McGinnity as well. Stopped by Rally. Donalo after this one shoves Doherty off the puck. Hughes tied up there in the neutral zone. And coming in now is Bayreuther. He'll ring that one around the Clarkson zone. Stopped by Doherty. Met by LeBrec. Holding here is Moore. Working up ice. Gets McGinnity. McGinnity through center ice. Trying to find Sexton, who was streaking there. Unable to get that one at the blue line, though. Is this one up ahead, just out of the reach of Burton. Icing going to be called. Burton just couldn't get enough of that one.
And now with this game tied up 3-3, we talked about Clarkson. Certainly in that third period, coming down by one, you want to try to get a goal in the first 10 minutes, and they've done that. Now getting this game back tied 3-3, 12-18 left in the third. Now for the next 10, you got to try to get some offensive zone pressure. You don't want to overextend, and you don't want to make a mistake right now, because one mistake could really end up costing you big in a game this getting into this late of the third period.
And, of course, Matt, we talked about it in the pregame. St. Lawrence kind of like that run-and-gun team, like very fast-paced games. They like to get the puck moving in the offensive zone, get players moving from side to side with some nice crisp passing. We've seen them do just that. But Clarkson also playing their game where – they like to sit back on defense, wait, and counterattack, and they did just that to tie this game up at 3-3. So both these teams kind of playing to their forte right now. The difference has been the goaltenders. Both of them making some timely saves as some bodies go flying there at center ice. And stepping in there, Frederick will make Sweetman pay the price for carrying that puck. Still trying to work this one free. Josephs will swat at it, picked up now by Howden. Out in off the boards, down the length of the ice, and after it now is Fossen. Fossen in a foot race. Wenninger will come out. Fossen throwing on the brakes there. Didn't want to run into the goaltender. Holding now is DeHaas. He'll delay, waiting for Josephs to tag back up. And going down is DeHaas. A couple players really seem to having some trouble with the skates. McGinnity with a shot that goes just wide. We've seen Matt carry a couple times, try to make some nice deep cut here on the ice, go down. Saw Fossen go down trying to stop there after going hard on Wenninger, and DeHaas going down as well. Maybe with the ice conditions starting to get pretty torn up out there. Usually the ice crew at Cheel keeps things pretty tip-top shape. Nonetheless, Boak will find this one. I'm sure the players will adjust. And this one in the corner, Donalo will scoop it out there. Back to McGovern. Shot going just wide. Picked up here. Trying to work it free is Dahl. Now to McGovern. Back to Austin. Austin at the blue line, shot towards Lewis, and he'll hold on to that one.
Picture perfect save there from Greg Lewis. Tracking that shot right into his chest, grabbing it and covering it up. A great job there by Greg Lewis, not allowing any rebounds there. He's been pretty good throughout this entire game, as has Matt Wenninger. A couple of these goals have been some pretty incredible plays on the offensive part, and both goalies have made some pretty incredible saves. Greg Lewis with two to note when Clarkson was down by one to keep them in this game.
Rally met along the boards there by Bissett, still trying to work this one free. Tying up there with Geiger was believe that's Martin, and now Martin working it free, sending back in front, trying to find Greg Carey, back to the near side for Bayreuther. Bayreuther had Frederick down on one knee. Frederick still getting in the way, causing all sorts of trouble, and Tansy losing a stick in the process. I believe Slash is going to be called here on SLU. Tansy getting back to a stick and his glove as that one's touched by Rally. Penalty going to be called. Slash going to be here on number 25, Chris Martin. 2 minutes slashing. That one was pretty easy for the referee when you see Kevin Tansy's stick come flying across his own.
Martin getting upset there with Kevin Tansy, a much bigger body. Tansy, of course, stands 6'3". Martin only about 6'1", not as big. Certainly not a guy to shy away from the physical contact, but Kevin Tansy doing a good job working him over in front, forcing Martin to get a little frustrated and taking that penalty. Now a great opportunity here for the Knights on the power play to try to get another one up on the board and see if they can't take the lead here against the Saints.
Excellent play there by Hughes, though, doing a good job to break up that D-to-D pass. And ahead now, racing with this one is Moore, working around one, causing the St. Lawrence defenders to run into each other, trying to work this one away from Baker. Tying up there, Sexton will find it, trying to work it free now. An effort now is Joe Zarbo, trying to get a piece of it, sends it back around the net. After it is Moore, getting a piece of it. Hopping back up to his feet now is Moore, sends it back out to the point, stopped and sent right back in. Sweetman holding here, had it trickle off of his stick, and now Doherty after it, swatted away there by Zarbo and finally lifted down the ice by the Saints. Under 10 minutes remain in the third. These two teams still tied up at 3. Of course, Matt, that's the score we saw last time St. Lawrence was in town last year. Well, granted, they're always in town, but last time they were here in Cheel was 3-3 last year. McGinnity now working this one ahead, trying to work it free. Comes back, LeBrec stops it here, wings it around for DeHaas. DeHaas with a drive, save Winninger, score, Jeff Dinallo. And boy, do we pick him, Matt. Game changer, Jeff Dinallo, pregame. You heard it first here on WCKN. And right now, as it stands, Jeff Dinallo with the go-ahead goal. 4-3, Clarkson on the power play. The parade to the penalty box continued, and the Knights made the Saints pay.
After two power play goals for the Saints, Clarkson now answers with their second. That time, Jeff Dinallo, not the biggest guy out on the ice, but he certainly tries just as hard as anybody else. That time does a great job to position himself off the side of the net. A hard shot from James DeHaas. The rebound bounces to Dinallo. And just as soon as he got there, it looked like that puck laid down nicely on the ice. He's able to fire off a shot that Matt Wenninger really had no chance on. Wenninger unable to get there. Needed some help from his defense. Dinallo with a great job getting in position to make that play.
This one picked up by Hudson. Takes a big hit there from Josephs. Back for Frederick, sent back in front. Josephs now battling with this one, trying to work it free there from Baker. After this one is Josephs. Big collision there, back from Frederick. Now to Howden, now back to Josephs. Score! And Matt Wenninger is livid right now.
Certainly looked to me like he had gotten interfered with in front. I'm a little surprised there wasn't a call. But a great job by Clarkson.
And Troy Josephs loving the crowd here, giving them some love in the corner, getting this crowd all fired up.
Nice job by Clarkson, even with Wenninger out of the net, as he's still trying to talk to the referee about that being interference. But a good job by Clarkson to finally get that puck in. They got the momentum from that fourth goal, did a great job of moving that puck around. It looked to me like Wenninger was interfered with, but a good job by Clarkson continuing to play, finding that puck in front, gets it to Troy Josephs, and a great job by Josephs to make sure that one ends up in the back of the net, not overthinking it and firing it into the back.
As it stands right now, though, that goal still on the board. So, Wenninger obviously still frustrated, had the helmet on the top of his head for a while, screaming at the referees. Couldn't really hear much of what was coming out of his mouth underneath what was being yelled by the pep band and the student section, really letting Matt Wininger have it. Of course, a favorite target of the Clarkson pep band. But we will see how things unfold. So Clarkson, in the past minute and a half, really doing a good job getting two goals up on the board. And they have a 5-3 lead right now as it stands. This one coming back, Greg Carey with a shot stopped in traffic. Tansy getting a piece of it, and now carried ahead by Matt Zarbo, dropping it back off for Bissett. Bissett now carrying it into the zone. Bissett holding here, shot going wide of the net. After it here is Lebrecht towards the net, stopped there by Rally. And Rally will play that one back around for Bayreuther. Bayreuther ahead for Martin. And Martin now dropping this one back off for Bayreuther. Bayreuther plays that one in. Stopping it is Lewis. He'll play it back around. He had Lebrecht behind the net. Trying to flick that one out was McGinnity. Couldn't get it past Riley Austin. McGinnity out now trying to find Dinalo. That one played up and out of play. Down in the corner. So a free souvenir on rivalry night here.
So now, if you're Clarkson, now up by two, a huge momentum swing there in the third period, able to get that goal with about 14 minutes left, and then two in pretty quick succession, the Jeff Dinalo lead, and then Troy Josephs adding his second of the year to give Clarkson the two-goal lead. Now for this last 7.5 minutes, would not be surprised. Clarkson tried to just ice away this game, tried to get out here with their 2 points that they've earned here in this third period. They've really outplayed St. Lawrence, done a great job of putting the pressure on, and have really made St. Lawrence beat themselves a little bit with some of those penalties that they took.
And Troy Joseph is a guy that you see playing this third line, draft pick of the Pittsburgh Penguins in the 7th round. Really a pretty good third line center that we've seen, and Troy Joseph's had a pretty solid game in the exhibition game against Queens, did some good things. He's been impressing me all season, not really in his point production, but just the way he carries himself on the ice, the pressure he puts on, and some of the skills he shows off. Really just an all-around good player and a nice recruit from Casey Jones.
Good player that he got in Troy Josephs. He's not the biggest. He's not the fastest. He's not even the best, but he goes out and he plays smart, and he does a really great job of fulfilling that third line center role for the Knights. Has some timely goal scoring as we've seen here tonight. Adds this one here to give Clarkson the 2-goal lead. A nice play by him to go to the front and have a stick on the ice waiting for that pass from James Howden.
Sweetman clears that one down the length of the ice. Dinalo got a piece of it, so Tansy will race after it. Swatting at it, trying to work it free there from, I believe that's Doherty in the corner. Tied up there, Tansy will lift that one down. Gloved by Rally, played out of the zone by McGinnity. Bayreuther will gather it for SLU. After this one now is Hughes. Hughes fanning on that one, taken out by Tansy as Hughes goes down. And that one's going to be called by the referee. Tansy with his head up. Didn't look like he stepped into Hughes with that much, but I believe the stick may have gotten caught up in the skates there. So Kevin Tansy going to be headed off for a trip.
Tansy trying to tie up his man along the boards, get the stick in between the legs of the SLU player. We're actually going to call holding here on Tansy, dragging his man down. So Kevin Tansy off to the box. A timely penalty here if you're St. Lawrence, a chance to get back into this game. Three in this third period, 6:09 left. Shots right now on the big board, 24-18 in favor of the Knights. St. Lawrence with a really good opportunity here to try to get one back on this and take this down to a 1-goal lead.
This one held here by Baker, dropping it back off for Bayreuther. So this top power play line, still out for SLU. Bayreuther will play that one hard off the glass. Howden getting there in time. He'll send it right back down the length of the ice. That's exactly what you want out here. This nice penalty kill right now. Don't allow them any room to move in and out on this SLU power play. As Dinalo gets to this one, chipped up into the Clarkson zone. Casey Jones going to give his team some appreciation. So tonight's attendance, 3,965. I believe that's third largest crowd we've had here in Cheel. So certainly packing the seats here tonight.
Also packing up the box upstairs, Casey Jones' office, a little bit of a window. Looks like there's about 20 or so people up there trying to get a view of this game.
Play it back in. Lewis will slow it down. Drops it off for Howden. Howden rings it around the boards. Gets back to the point. Back now for Sweetman. Sweetman plays that one gently to Doherty. Now back to Sweetman. Sweetman across now. Gets that one to Ward. Now back to Doherty. Stop there. Boak plays it hard out of the zone. And of course, Matt, we mentioned Casey Jones packing that. The stands are packed, but not only that. The concourse seems to be packed. A lot of standing room. A lot of people standing. And of course, you and I are probably going to be in the same boat tomorrow night and when we head down the road to Appleton to see what should be a very good second game of this home-and-home series.
Teams always play each other hard. You said how we usually see Clarkson play on a Tuesday night in St. Lawrence, and then on a Saturday, St. Lawrence will come to Clarkson. ECAC conference scheduling, switching it up a little bit, doing it this way. I think I like this a little bit more. Sometimes it's hard to make the trek out there on a Tuesday night. You know, we all like to be in bed at about 9 or so here at Clarkson. We like to get our rest, especially during dead week.
Of course, this one played back in by the St. Lawrence Saints. Swatting at it is Geiger, still trying to kill off the remaining 5 seconds here. As this one played back by Bayreuther. Knights able to kill off that one as LeBrec able to lift that back out of the zone. That went off the shaft of the stick of Howden, and out to play it was Wenninger over the glove of Burton. And this one played back ahead now, and chasing after it is Hudson. Hudson will grab it, poked away by Boak. Coming in to the play was Howden as well. He'll hop back up to his feet as Boak will corral for the Knights. Picking his head up and starting this one back up the ice is Boak across ice, gets it to Burton. Burton ahead trying to find Frederick and just out of his reach. Now Riley Austin will turn ahead for SLU, carrying this one ahead, got it there to McGovern. McGovern taking out of the play, and DeHaas now will scoop this one back up. 3:30 or a little bit less remaining in the third. Picked up here by Fawson. Fawson trying to get this one around. Riley Austin taken down, sends that one towards the net. Nothing going to be called on the play. Clean play by Riley Austin. Of course, not so many people in the stands agree, but from up here, pretty clean from Riley Austin.
Good play as A.J. Fawson trying to come in. I thought that was a good job as Fawson was trying to duck down, putting a little bit of pressure on him and knocking him off his skates. Wasn't a hook, wasn't a trip. To me, that's a good call by the referees. No penalty there as Fawson tried to break in on Wenninger.
And now Joseph's going to be ahead of the box. And slow to get up on that one is Riley Austin. Now Doherty will carry this one, and Austin will head back to the bench, touching this one. Knights have yet to do some. And holding on this one is Greg Carey. Back around for Doherty, and that one's held by Lewis.
And Doherty really unhappy with himself, as it looked like Greg Lewis was a little slow getting over there. Doherty really should have taken another second or so on that shot. Maybe tried to get it over to the left. It looked like he almost shot it right back to where where Greg Lewis was. Not the best of plays there by Doherty. You can see he's still physically frustrated with himself after that. Ben Stexton still having some conversations. Troy Joseph is going to go off to the box. 2 minutes for the slash. Looked like he got it. The back of the leg of one of the St. Lawrence defensemen. I believe it was Riley Austin, the senior. So Troy Joseph's the man who has that fifth goal, off to the box. 2:27 left in the third period. 2 minutes for the slash. Clarkson going to have another opportunity to kill off this St. Lawrence power play. They've done a good job on the last couple opportunities that SLU has had. See if they can continue the hot streak and keep St. Lawrence off the board.
And Matt, this may be fortunate for the Knights. Crazy to say that a penalty kill may favor a team, but Clarkson really having some troubles getting out of their own zone. SLU really putting on the pressure, but with this penalty kill really allows them to just kind of clear it down the length of the ice, avoid some danger, and scoring that one is Matt Carey. That's his second of the night. So as soon as I bring it up, the Saints make the Knights pay. They only trail by one, as it is now 4-3 as Matt Carey gets his second of the night as that one goes off the iron and back in.
It's actually going to be 5-4 Clarkson as St. Lawrence capitalizes less than 30 seconds in to that penalty to Troy Josephs. And that's really sucked a lot of the life out of this building, that shot from Matt Carey. He's certainly a very talented kid. That one, a nice shot. Gets it in off the post, beating Greg Lewis over his blocker high. And now Clarkson, with just about 2 minutes left in this third, really needs to buckle down on the defense and finish out this game, try to get out of here with these 2 points in conference play.
Danilo trying to work this one free. Doherty will carry it ahead for the Saints. Poked out there by Tansy. Joining the fray as well is Hughes, getting some help from Dahl as this one goes cross ice there for Baker. Baker holding, sending it back down. Tansy will intercept that pass. He's got McGinnity with him as well, as Tansy will just lift that one in, and the Knights will get some fresh legs over the boards, get that line change late with 1:30 left. Holding onto this one now is Baker, and Matt will be keeping our eye on Wenninger to see if he gets pulled. That one played up ahead. Pressure, and out comes Greg Carey. Wenninger headed to the bench. Extra attacker on. Greg Carey shot stopped by Boak. Boak finding this one. Still trying to get it out of the zone. Boak lifting that one down and the length of the ice into the SLU zone. Picked up here and now ahead for Martin. Martin had it poked away from Sexton, and that one's going to go wide of the net. Martin will play it back around there for Wick, and Wick will hold. 50 seconds remain as this one played ahead now for Matt Carey. He's got two already on the night. Lifting that one into the ninth zone after it now is Howden. Big collision there with Martin, and Boak will tie up his man as well. Viciously spinning around there was Greg Carey as he'll pick this one up. It comes back to Baker. Baker across now for Bayreuther. He had Burton down on a knee. Chasing after this one, Bayreuther will play it back around. After it now is Frederick. Frederick still trying to get this one loose, poking at it here.
The referee blowing the whistle as Frederick was down on both knees, just sort of toppled over on top of that puck.
So timeout taken by St. Lawrence with 20.5 left. We'd like to take this time to remind you that timeouts here sponsored by Josie's Pizzeria with two convenient locations in Potsdam and Canton. Stop by Josie's and try a slice. We'd also like to remind you that the Clarkson Golden Knights Hockey is a production of WCKN Television in association with the Golden Knights and is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of the accounts, descriptions, or pictures from this game without the express written consent of WCKN and Clarkson University is prohibited.
Casey Jones, I'm sure, telling his guys down there, breaking out the whiteboard, probably try to draw up a face-off plan here. He's got one of the best in the country in Ben Sexton. This Clarkson team as a whole, excellent on the face-offs. St. Lawrence in desperate need of one here. Clarkson was a little bit behind, I believe 13-10 in that first, but really came back in the second period and dominated the face-off dot. St. Lawrence right now having a conversation with their coach. Of the guys out there, you got to know they're going to probably be trying to get it to big number 10, Greg Carey, or his brother Matt. Matt has really been dynamic, and I think that's been a lot because of what Clarkson has had to do to silence Greg Carey for the most part here tonight. Greg Carey actually going to come in to step in and take this faceoff against Clarkson's captain, Ben Sexton. This is a very important faceoff here.
And now Sexton's going to get thrown out of the dot. Not exactly happy. Danilo will come in as Danilo was tied up there with Matt Carey. Back for Baker. Baker holding onto this one. Swings back around for Bayreuther. Shot loose in traffic. Puck squares back out. Bayreuther will hold it. Back for Baker. Baker here works it back to the near side. Holding for Greg Carey. Shot. Loose puck still. Loose puck still in the crease. Covered by Lewis. Greg Carey going in there. And things are getting violent. Still no whistle yet. And Greg Lewis up and just throwing people around. And things are getting very out of hand.
Greg Carey came into the Clarkson net very, very late. And Greg Lewis really took exception to that.
And Greg Carey really, there was that big scrum down on the ice. Puck was underneath of everything. And Greg Carey kind of ran and just dove into that pile somehow. Not sure why he would do such a thing. I don't know if you can score by diving on the puck. I haven't seen it written in the rules that you're allowed to. But things got out of hand. Helmets are missing. We'll see what the referees make out of all this. You never know. You could get game game misconducts. You could also get game disqualifications coming out of this, which would play huge implications in the game tomorrow night.
Looks like joining Greg Carey in the penalty box, going to be number 19, Jeremy Wick, one of the goal scorers for St. Lawrence here tonight. Referee bringing Greg Carey his helmet. It's now Al McPherson having a little bit of a talk.
And as you can see, the SLU bad boy box. Gracious, as we refer to her, the sign lady up here really does a good job to deck out Cheel Arena with all the signs you see along the glass. She's here every game, same seat, straight across from us. Really kind of brings a homey type atmosphere to Cheel Arena. Of course, 4.9 left. Referee's still trying to sort all this out. McPherson will be out there. Of course, no player really wearing an A. And a 5-minute penalty being assessed to Greg Carey. We'll see what happens. If this is just a game misconduct, or if he gets a game disqualification, of course. Greg Carey visibly frustrated with how he was treated, of course, when he was being escorted off to the penalty box with the linesman kind of acknowledging the Cheel fans here. Give him a little bit of a wave.
And Ben Sexton in the box for Clarkson as well. Wick in the box for the Saints. And it looks like Carey's gonna get the extra here. Looked like he was really in the scrum, in the middle of it, caused it, and then was really out there with his stick, pulling a little bit of a Phil Kessel, going at a couple of the Clarkson players. Certainly Greg Carey frustrated with the way this game turned out for him. Didn't get very much open ice, was visibly showing, and then his emotions right at the end here a little bit riding over.
So charging going to be the call assessed to Greg Carey. I'd say that's a fair assessment from the referees and the speed and intensity he went in that pile. Tie up here, puck will drop down. DeHaas holding here. And now Frederick is going to exchange words with Hughes. And you know, Matt, I'm beginning to maybe think that the ECAC scheduled the two games in December and January for a reason. It's going to be scary tomorrow night in Appleton if these two teams have tempers flare like they have here late.
Will Frederick going off to the box, as is Gunnar Hughes. Right now you're Casey Jones. You got to try to calm your team down, trying to get out the last 4 seconds. Somehow we got another penalty squeezed in there. Wouldn't it be a Clarkson St. Lawrence rivalry with a couple of extra pushing and shoving matches?
You know, Matt,
there's actually going to be another St. Lawrence player into the box. Number 9, Alex Hagan. I think he's going to be serving that penalty for Greg Carey.
Puck drop here, and these players knowing that the game should be over, and McPherson a little bit visibly frustrated going after him, and now tempers are going to flare. Team's going to stay on either side of the ice, as McPherson just wanted to get that puck at the end of the game, maybe a souvenir or a memento, prevented from doing so by Doherty, who will take this one, and now both teams going to be escorted to their appropriate locker rooms. Matt, things are going to be heated tomorrow night. But anyway, the Knights come away with a 5-4 victory. Game-winning goal is going to go to Troy Josephs. We'll get you back for a quick postgame. Stay tuned here on WCKN. Came from behind. game-winning goal.
Doing
Arena, the Knights come away victorious 5-4 over the St. Lawrence Saints. Game winner goes to Troy Josephs. And Matt, that got really ugly there at the end of the game. Tempers flaring. It took us a little while to go through 4.5 seconds that it really shouldn't have taken. And things should be interesting. I'm thinking the ECAC probably pretty smart in the past scheduling a December game at St. Lawrence and a January game here, so tempers could kind of level out. But both these teams going to see each other tomorrow night. It should be interesting, to say the least. But what did you see from both these teams tonight so far?
Well, both of these teams came out, and this was certainly not a game that was short on entertainment. It was a great game to watch from the start. A good job by Clarkson coming into the game. Really did a good job in that first period for a little while, but then St. Lawrence dominated the first. Clarkson came out and actually, I thought, played really well in the second, even though they ended up losing that period by giving up that goal. And then obviously in the third, Clarkson comes out, a lot of momentum, comes in, gets all those goals up on the board, ending with the goal from Troy Josephs. He gets the game winner.
So, of course, that goal from Josephs. Matt Winninger was furious after that shot from Josephs on basically a wide-open net. Maybe thought Winninger was interfered with. He had his word with the referee. Almost broke his stick over the back of the net. That was a nice feed there from Howden to Josephs. And Winninger visibly frustrated after that. As you can see, Josephs, of course, loving every minute of it, getting that game winner, his first game against St. Lawrence. And then, of course, things got out of hand. SLU put one on the board with Matt Carey, who had an outstanding game. And pretty solid game all around, though. Matt, who would your three stars be for tonight?
Well, three stars, I'm going to look at number three. I'm going to go Jeff Dinallo. Talked about him as our game changer for the game, and he certainly did that. He was the guy that gave Clarkson their fourth goal, which led to them getting that momentum into the fifth. Obviously, for St. Lawrence, their best player all night was Matt Carey. This kid is dynamic. He's a great puck handler. He's a great skater, and he's a really good shooter. Showed it a couple of times. He was outstanding. But really, the game comes down to that goal from Troy Josephs. An excellent job by him all game. Doesn't get a lot of ice time, but he really is efficient with his time out there. Makes every second count. Goes hard. Plays well in both zones. Can win you some faceoffs, and he showed tonight He's even got a couple of good goals in him. We talked about clutch with Jared Burton and that goal that he scored. Troy Joseph showing that he can be a little bit clutch for this Clarkson University team.
So Clarkson's going to come away with the victory. They'll get 2 points. They'll head down the road, if you can call it a road trip, to Canton to take on the Saints tomorrow night at 7. Before that can happen, though, the Lady Knights take on the University of North Dakota in the second game of their home series. We'll see what happens, and that will be the last hockey we have for you for the semester. So come back and watch some more hockey with us tomorrow here on WCKN.